Hello, everyone. Hope you're all doing well. Oh my god, I almost... I almost choked on some phlegm in my throat the moment I opened my mouth, so it's good to see that we're starting off great as usual. Aw, look at all those heart emotes in chat. No, I'm so glad that one's getting a lot of views. I'm very happy about that. So, how was that game show, eh? It was a lot of fun, wasn't it? And thankfully we didn't burn any bridges. Luxium is still intact. Oh my gosh. I need to... Oh my god, there's a lot of memberships coming in. Thank you all so much. And an Akaspa from... was that Laverne Lau? Perhaps? Yes. Yes, it was. Thank you very much. You just said M. Wasn't... I believe that used to be a meme, wasn't it? Oh, I should have known. It's a rainbow. It's a rainbow. Of course it is. M-I. Me. Welcome to the penmanship. Miss. M-I-S? Miss? Hold on. I'm curious. What are you spelling? Laverne, what are you spelling? Miss? What am I missing? I mean, I know I have terrible aim in Apex, but what am I missing? Aw, miss you. Aw. That's so sweet. Thank you. Thank you for the rainbow and... The divided up message. Aww. Aw, you're complete for the Nemo. That's so sweet. But, I haven't been gone, have I? I was at the game show yesterday, and before that, I was on Vox's stream. So, if you guys caught that, then you'd been hanging with me quite a bit. But, today, it's just me and you guys, and this game that we call Firewatch. From what I've heard, this is kind of similar to What Remains of Edith Finch, but it's not as depressing, and also the visuals are supposed to be really, really nice. Then that's about everything I know about it, and I have it open right now, and actually, that's a good point. Let's go over to Game Capture and have a look at this. Because, wow. Look at this. This is kind of pretty, isn't it? I've had this open for a couple of minutes now, and I wish more title screens were like this. I really like things that are very quiet and subdued. Usually when there's a title screen, there's just loud, bombastic music, blaring trumpets, brass, and everything, and I just have to turn down the volume or mute the game entirely. Here, the game just stays open in the background, it runs, and you just have this beautiful little visual and the sounds of nature. It's looking pretty anime. You know what? I can kind of see that. It kind of looks like some of those watercolor paintings that you see in the backgrounds of a lot of anime. Oh my god, Laverne, are you doing... Wait, Miss... It's in both directions. Miss... Wait. M-I-S-S... Am I being silly? Hold on. Oh my god, hold on. I'm curious. I need to figure out. What are you spelling it? Miss you, love you. Aww. You guys. You're always so clever. That's so sweet. Thank you. And that's very generous as well. Thank you so much. The rainbow chat. Not really a rainbow chat, but Now you know what, that's a rainbow chat, because like spacing up a message like that, with the different letters for the colors of the super chat, that's pretty Chad. That is pretty Chad. Okay, I have a drink with me, as always. You already know what it is. Ah. Oh, that's delicious. And with that, let's get into this. Let's see what this beautiful looking game has in store for us. New game. New game. Let me know if the audio is okay. Campo Santo presents. In cooperation with Panic Inc. Sounds like a restaurant. Colorado, 1975. UC Julia. Okay, who and what is Julia? Oh. She's about your age, late 20s, laughing with well-dressed professors and grad students from nearby CU Boulder. You, Henry, are drinking with your pals. You approach her. Oh, okay. It's like a story. Nice. You are drunk. So, what's your, you know, major? You're pretty. I guess this one? You slur the words major, and it smells like Coors? Coors? You give an awkward smile. Evolutionary biology, she says. And I'm a professor. Cool, you reply. What's yours? She asks. She sniffs the air. Toxicology? Ooh. Was that a burn? You ask. She says definitely. Worried she hurt your feelings, she asks if you want to split a cheeseburger. One week later, and you're Julia's boyfriend. Oh, look at you go, Henry. Oh. My car? Yes. Didn't you secure that a bit better? You date for over a year. She drives you absolutely nuts. It's great. You move in, you share an apartment near the school with a view of the mountains. You drink beers out on the deck. You drink beer just about anywhere. Life is good. Julia wants to get a dog. There's a scruffy, undersized beagle. Julia is in love. She wants to bring it with her to class. There's also an intimidating but gentle-eyed German shepherd. Nothing bad could happen to Julia while walking this dog. It's badass. You pick up the beagle and she names him Bucket. You adopt the shepherd and name him Mayhem. I can't help it. I really, really like German Shepherd. I really like German Shepherds. But a beagle named Bucket, it's adorable. Hold on. I'm gonna do this. Okay, heads, it's Bucket. Tails, it's Mayhem. Okay, heads, Bucket, tails, Mayhem. bucket it is. Thank you, Google. Bucket's a good dog, and a week later, you've totally forgotten about the other one. Julia loves him. You love him too. You talk out on the deck. It's summer. 9:30 p.m., and the heat still radiates off of the high desert. What do you think about kids? She asks. Ugh, loaded question. Kids? They're not very smart, or good at much. I'm saying if you and I have some, a couple of little idiots. Do I answer as myself or as Henry? As yourself? Well, in that case, kids is a lot. I can barely take care of myself. I should not be entrusted with the responsibility for somebody else, much less a human being. She looks away, out towards the mountains. We have plenty of time, right? Speak for yourself, mister. Don't worry, you assure her. You tell her she has the body of an undergrad. My ovaries didn't get the memo, she says, laughing it off. One day, okay? Okay. One day, she says. 6 months later, you get engaged, lying in bed on a Sunday morning. Aww. Okay, wow, this is pretty. Thoroughfare Trailhead. I can even read the fine print. No fireworks. Seems like common sense stuff. It's a Thursday night, and Julia is 4 hours late. She doesn't call. You're worried and getting angrier by the minute. She walks in after you've gone to bed. She's not quite drunk, but she's clearly been having a fun time. You fight when she gets between the sheets. Getting mad isn't gonna solve it, but... Both of these are bad! Both of these are bad! Getting mad isn't gonna solve anything. Like, this is the... Like, resorting to, like, shouting or, like, arguing isn't gonna solve much, so sometimes it's better to just let things simmer down on their own. You don't touch each other all night. The next day, you feel guilty for being so angry and ask her about the evening. She says it was great. She says it was great. You hold on to a tiny pill of resentment. You make some coffee and go to work. Come on. Julia likes to draw. She draws plans from her research. She draws all the places you go to. She draws you. You pose and flex like He-Man. You frolic like a Victoria's Secret model. I don't know. He-Man's pretty based. You look awesome. It's bad that whenever I think of He-Man, I think about Hey, yeah. That one. Oh my god, look, this is gorgeous. Can I just, like, print screen? This is beautiful. There we are. 1982. During the summers, you and Julia enjoy walking Bucket at night. Oh, that carries over. Nice. There's a festival in town. It brings in folks from faraway places. One of them tries to mug you with a knife? What? Bucket gets... Bucket gets kicked. I don't even know how to read this. Beba fuck dog. Julia yells. She gets flustered and has trouble speaking when she's stressed. You confront the attacker. You heard my dog, you're getting beat up. Your arm gets cut up, but you beat the guy to a pulp. You don't feel very tough. You cry your eyes out before the cops show up. Julia asks to take a different path from that day forward. You say okay. You don't want to go that way either. From then on, you walk by the river. Okay, maybe this is gonna be depressing, oh no. 1984. Plans to have kids get waylaid by work. Julia gets offered a job at Yale. Yale is in Connecticut, 2,000 miles away. It's a great job. Associate department chair. She wants to move. You absolutely do not. Convince her not to take the job. Agree if she commutes. I hate both of these. I hate both of these. If it's a great opportunity, then I would want to encourage someone. I guess this is the closest. You ask her if she'll commute back and forth. You don't want to move to Connecticut. She says that'll be hard, but she'll do it if you won't move. You tell her not to pass it up, if it is what she wants. She agrees. She flies back to Boulder 3 times each semester. 1985. Julia is sent home from Yale on paid leave after having, quote-unquote, an episode. She lost it on a colleague for borrowing books that were important to her research. She didn't remember that she had happily loaned them to him just 2 days prior. She was found crying in the stairwell. You say that maybe you guys should talk to someone about it. Make macaroni and drink wine and try to forget about it. No. After seeing multiple doctors and having many tests, they are worried that Julia might be suffering from early onset dementia. She's 41. We both decide to keep it a secret for now. Oh my god, hello? Really, game? Avert your eyes, Quildren. Severe mood whiplash. Okay. I wonder if I'm gonna have to edit that out later. Hopefully not. Bucket is getting older. Julia comments that it's kind of nice because he gets into less trouble around the house. A week later, she goes back to the university. Hmm. 1987. Julia's affliction gets worse. She can't remember things in class. Her research is in shambles. She drives her car to the next town over for no particular reason. And has to be brought home by the police. She is devastated. She is sent home on permanent medical leave.
Some days, you get the Julia who calls you a dope, and your unborn children little idiots. Other days, you get a stranger. She pulls you into bed to make love. After 5 minutes, she goes into a panic, believing her dad is at the door. You tell her family. They are crushed and begin to make trips to and from their home in Australia to visit her. For a while, her friends come by with little things to brighten her day. She gets worse. You spend your days following Julia around the house. You count the seconds between the 2 weekly visits from Daniel, the nurse. He suggests that Julia could live somewhere else, somewhere with 24-hour care, a home. It sits with you for a couple of months. You decide to move her to a full-time care facility. You're determined to take care of her by yourself. This is a difficult decision because 24-hour care sounds very tempting. It's in a safe place with access to help that she could desperately need whenever she might need it. But I can only imagine how lonely that would get. In a place where you don't really know anybody, you're cut off from friends and family who only get to visit you occasionally. On the other hand, taking care of someone by yourself, they're in a place they call home. They're surrounded by people they know and care about, and that care for them. But at the end of the day, this is just Henry, I think his name was, is just a regular person. He's not educated for this. I mean, I guess you can learn. You can get advice. You can still get visits from a nurse. It may be selfish, maybe foolish. I can't see myself picking anything else.
Ah! I'm kind of welling up. What the heck? I hate this. At least the game is really pretty. Hello.
It is impossibly hard. The worst is when you get mad at her. Like when she tries to cook her own food. You can't do anything without her, and she can't do anything without you. When she goes to sleep, you stay up for a few hours, drinking on the deck, watching baseball in the summer, college basketball in the winter, drinking then too. You start going out after you put her to bed. First time you do and you do it, you worry about her getting up and walking around while you're gone. You put a chair in front of the bedroom door. Don't do this, Jesus. You go to the same bar at the boring end of Pearl Street. It's nice there. Over time, you tell Sheila? I think Sheila. The bartender, everything. It's a huge way off. We're home and in bed by 1 a.m. a couple of nights a week. We look forward to those nights. Oh my god. 1989. One night you are stopped at a DUI checkpoint. You blow a .10 or are taken to jail for the night. You consider trying to hide it, but you tell your sister-in-law, Susan. Dude, this guy is so irresponsible. What the heck? Julia's parents take the next plane from Australia. They can't believe the state your house is in. They tell you Julia's coming to live with them. You don't argue. You say you'll visit soon. A few weeks go by. Summer's coming, and you see an ad in the paper for a job. You take it. I assume that's fire watching. Oh, this is gorgeous. I'm gonna be saying that a lot. Enter the lookout tower. You got it. Can I run? I cannot. Oh, this is beautiful. Like the painted, like, mountains in the sky. I love good art direction. Yes, here we are. It's rather cozy, honestly. Turn on the power. Well, that was easy. There we are.
Hello, Two Forks Tower.
Hello?
Tower, this is Thoroughfare Tower. Oh. Come in.
Reply. How do I... Yeah, how do I do that? Oh, shift. And then I scroll, and then do I just let go?
Hello? Whoever this is?
It's Henry, right?
Yeah.
I'm Delilah.
Yeah, that's what the guy said on the phone.
So, what's wrong with you?
Excuse me?
People take this job to get away from something, so what's wrong?
What's wrong with you?
That's a great idea. Go ahead.
Look, I just hiked for 2 days, so I don't really follow whatever it is you're doing right now.
You take a stab at what's wrong with me.
Fine, then can I sleep forever?
Sure, buddy. Okay, now go ahead.
One moment. The game's really quiet. Let me see if I can fix that. Okay, let's try that. Resume. What are these options?
Okay, you're probably just rebelling against a mom who wishes you had given her grandkids, by the sound of your voice, at least 15 years ago. You come out here and it really grinds her gears and you love it. Can I sleep now?
Well, she also says I fuck immature men, but in my defense, who wouldn't want a 28-year-old with ambition and energy and some fire in his belly in bed?
Me, I'm going now.
Just a second, now it's my turn.
Okay, good
night. What is this dialogue?
I don't know anything about you. I say you got fired from your job and have finally decided to write your novel. That's the sort of bullshit reason you'll find a man out in the woods.
Good night.
Welcome to the job.
I would write my novel in a cabin. Why not? It seems like a good place. Oh no, I am being called up!
Well, good afternoon. You probably slept like a rock. Anyway, there's still a few hours of daylight to get some work in. I can see you at your desk, so call me when you're ready.
I am really being called out, am I? Answer radio. Delilah, was it?
Hey, sorry. Guess I slept in.
You got a relaxing, what, 14 hours of sleep? Whew.
Yeah, Jesus. I guess it's, what, 6?
6:45.
Whoops.
Don't worry about it. That hike puts everyone out of commission for a day or two. But now that you're up, let me quickly get you acquainted with the job. There's a thing in the middle of your room with a round map on it. Do you see it?
Okay. Hold on, it's still kind of quiet. I'm so used to games being unbearably loud. Can't believe I'm putting this at 100. A photo with Julia?
It's right in the middle of your room.
Oh, sorry.
You can't miss it.
Okay, yeah, I see it.
This is the Osborne Firefinder, invented in 1914 by W.B.
Osborne?
You use this to spot, you guessed it, what the fuck?
What is it?
Nothing. You use this to... Oh, fuck me!
Good God, language, lady.
I was about to say the same.
Window. Are you seeing what I'm seeing?
West? West? Oh God, my sense of direction.
Fucking fireworks?
Where? Am I blind? Oh, no, those are fireworks.
Whoa, that's not legal, right?
No. You need to get down there right now and stop them. Fire danger is through the fucking roof.
Is that really my job?
Your job is whatever I say it is. Look, the closest ranger is like 2 days away. Go down there and set him straight. Do you think you can handle that?
This one is kind of funny, I'm sorry.
Like, kick the shit out of him sort of straight?
No. Jesus, no.
Sorry.
No, I'm not a cop. It's not like I've got a rule book over here.
Just make sure they don't do it again. Take their shit.
All right, fine.
Don't feed anyone a knuckle sandwich. Get going. You'll probably need a rope to get down the shale between you and the lake, if I remember right. There should be one in the supply box on the way.
Okay.
The code is 1234. It's actually that for all of them.
Smart.
Smart.
Shut up.
Okay, the voice acting is freaking great. The delivery and everything, it's great. I'm, like, no complaints about that whatsoever. Hmm. No, don't do that. Pine cone. Okay, but why though? Is there anything else in here? Singular mine. Okay. Water jug. This is kind of cozy, I'm not gonna lie. Bleach? Chlortox. Okay, that's... Do I get this? Okay. Okay, which direction was the fireworks? Oh, yep, there they are. Okay, so where's the rope, though? Hop over? Oh, okay. Okay, what direction was it now again? I guess... this way? The game is so pretty. I feel like I could fall asleep, too. Like, this is another one of these games that you can put on in the background and just kind of fall asleep, too. It's so peaceful. It's like I'm actually going on a walk in the woods, except the woods are a lot prettier. Oh, is that the one? Where it says 1, 2, 3, 4?
I found the supply box.
Great!
So are there a lot of these out in the woods?
Yeah, we got them all over the Shoshone. They saved us a lot of back and forth from the trailhead. Don't take all the good stuff.
Yeah, alright. Hey, what's the code again?
1, 2, 3, 4. A whole lot of them.
Okay, 1, 2, three, four. Oh. Okay.
Hey, I found a note to a guy named Ron from some guy Dave.
That's probably Dave Gaskell. He's completely nuts.
Is that right?
Harmless, but yeah. One of those, you know, fall off the grid and eat ants for a week type? Totally fucking cuckoo. Which is kind of what the job attracts.
Do people lose their shit doing this job? There's a note that says a guy just left his post.
It happens, yeah. You're not gonna pop your top, are you, Henry?
I wasn't planning on it. Hey, there's a snack in here. Probably gonna eat it.
You definitely do not want to do that. Whatever's in there has been in there for years. That's how you get food poisoning.
You listening, mister?
I tracked down that rope. It was right where you said.
Great. So you should be set to get down to the lake.
Okay, nice. Can I take this with me? No. I think I just ate it. Guess not. Oh well. I pulled a mister, and I didn't mean to. Disclaimer, don't eat expired things. And also don't eat things that you randomly just find. God, what are these sounds? Okay, over there. Can I not run? Oh, I can run. Bless. Okay, that's close.
This shale slide is steep. How do you expect me to get down this?
I don't remember it being that bad. It's not even named on our topos.
Creeper Gulch? Widowmaker? What about that?
What about Shitty Boss is gonna get me killed hill?
Oh, is that Absorca Indian? Maybe Creek?
That's actually English for not in my job description. How do you expect me to get down this?
Well, did you get that rope?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay, just lash it to something nearby and take it slow.
Everybody's so spicy in this. God. Wait, what did that say? Oh my god, it's actually named that. That's great attention to detail. Rattle. This is not that steep. You could climb down this. This is not that bad.
No!
Okay, maybe I said nothing.
Hey.
What the hell's wrong with you?
Said ow.
My shitty boss almost got me killed.
First, your boss is a delight. Secondly, Jesus. What exactly happened?
My rope snapped coming down the shale slide.
You didn't break anything, did you?
No, I think I'll make it.
Well, be careful for Christ's sake.
Is the sun going down? I guess it is. I didn't know, like, that the... there was passage of time in this. Oh, it's so pretty, though. I don't remember what the shortcut for screenshots on Steam is.
It is a hell of a nice camping spot down here by the lake.
I haven't been down there in years, but yeah, Jonesy Lake area is perfect.
I'm staring at the big outcropping down here, but I'm not quite sure where to look for our
F-12?
Missions.
Maybe keep heading west toward the lake.
Thank you. I'm gonna get a lot of mileage out of that. What is this?
Finding a bunch of empty beer cans. They threw them all over hell.
Are you fucking serious?
Yeah, sure am.
I would like to retract my statement about knuckle sandwiches. Feet away.
What do you know? People with shitty manners drink shitty beer.
What, you don't like a cold Musquelite on a hot day?
No, I do. But then again, I didn't say my manners were any good. Better than these fucking litter bugs, though, that's for sure.
Red Eagle, brewed in Wyoming.
You know what? Fuck it. I'm not the maid.
Can we clean this up? Oh, I can. Nope. Nice. Oh, what's that?
They left their packs tied up here.
Don't fuck with them. The last thing we need is some hikers filing a report about harassment.
I mean, they are kind of acting really irresponsible. He's not even stomped out.
Oh, look, they decided to have a campfire, too.
You know, they color-coded the fire danger signs in case people were illiterate. But I guess that doesn't take into account just plain stupid, does it?
Yeah, no kidding.
Well, I put out their fire.
Man, I would've named that forest fire something good, too.
Hey, I can always restart it.
No. I think your first instinct was the right one.
They left half a bottle of whiskey. Decent stuff.
Drunk pyromaniacs. Fucking great.
Can I take this with me? Yes, I can.
Found the fireworks. They didn't even try to hide them.
Well, confiscate them.
Seems to clean up after these jerks, too.
Well, they left their clothes out to dry. It looks like two people. What if they're naked?
Won't that be exciting? Look, they're obviously still there, so tell them off and then head back.
Am I gonna have to black out the screen? Does anybody know? Am I gonna have to black out the screen?
I found a bra.
A nudie pyromaniac. Remain professional.
Oh my god.
There are, panties?
What?
I don't want to say that word again.
Why, because you're 12?
I feel attacked. I don't like this game anymore. It can be as pretty as it'd like. I don't feel attacked. I don't like it here.
I found them in the lake.
Skinny dipping?
Yeah.
Is that a guy over there?
Oh boy. Enjoy dealing with that.
This one.
I know you guys are setting up bottle rockets out here, okay?
How? Because you're hiding in the bushes, spying on us?
Give him a break, Lily. He probably hasn't seen boobs in 20 years.
Probably still a virgin.
Jesus.
Why do guys think it's all right to just stare at girls?
Look, I'm sorry for bothering you. Can you just knock it off, please?
Yeah, you should be. This is a free country, and we should be free to do whatever we want. And free from any peeping Tom.
I said sorry.
Literally fire hazard. Hello? Okay, you know what? Can I take this with me? Can I eat this? Oh!
Hey, that go okay?
I'm fine.
It went fine. Hopefully there won't be any more trouble.
Good. Thanks for going down there.
I wonder where they went. They just kind of vanished.
Hey, there's a trail to Two Forks Tower down here near the lake.
Yeah, that's your tower.
So I should go this way.
Well, you're not climbing back up that slide.
Oh yeah, that's true. Okay, where do I go? Is it this path or... There is a path over here.
Well, this lake does seem like a good spot to swim, even if the last people to do so were assholes.
Yeah, right now, though, it's all snowmelt, so you'll freeze your balls off. But as hot as it's been, maybe that's a fair trade.
Starting to feel like it.
What? The dialogue between these two. Oh. I swear I saw something. Oh, well. And 1, 2, 3, 4. What does that do? Map? Can I press M? Oh, I can. Can't really read it. Oh, there we are. Shitty boss is gonna get me killed, Hill. I like the consistency. Got some bad news back home, so hopefully they'll let me out of here for a while. Who's to say, though, budgets being what they are? Did you get my note about what went down in Opiti? Sheriff isn't too pleased with me, but I don't know. I probably overdid it. Wish you would have been there. I guess you must have gotten hung up. Dave, P.S. Amigos in Spanish. Amigos is Spanish, and profesionales is Italian. Okay.
I found a sweatshirt from the University of Eastern Colorado.
There's a University of Eastern Colorado?
I really don't think there is.
Why would somebody make that up?
Right, and then put it on a sweatshirt.
The world's a weird place.
Can I take this with me? Oh. I guess not. What was the point of that? Was that, like, at all necessary, or was that optional? Man, I feel like I'm gonna be missing a lot of stuff if there's, like, optional stuff.
I take it you fell prey to the Forest Service's big recruiting effort? When it comes to, you know, how the hell you ended up out here?
What does that mean?
Sorry, I don't really know what you mean by recruiting effort.
Oh, after last summer. You know, budgets went through the roof, a lookout, and every lookout for the first time in 20 years.
Last summer?
Oh, come on, you're from Denver, not Delaware. This was national news for Pete's sake.
Boulder. I'm from Boulder.
Same diff.
This one, I guess?
So are you gonna let me know what happened that caused this budget increase, or what?
I can't believe you don't know.
I was a little preoccupied last summer.
Jeez. I mean, the federal government almost let Yellowstone National Park burn to the ground? Ring a bell?
Yellowstone is, like, what, 15 miles away? Why would they do that?
Well, the short story is that for 60 years, we got very good at not letting forest fires happen. And then about 15 years ago, they decided that forest fires in wilderness areas like Yellowstone should be left to burn. So that's what they did. I can't believe you didn't hear about this.
That sounds like a terrible idea.
The entire park was gone. Dan Rather telling the country that President Reagan didn't care on the nightly news. I mean, what the hell's he gonna do? Smoke jump in and snuff one out for the Gipper?
So what should they have done?
I don't even know. By the time the Yellowstone folks realized the little fires weren't gonna burn themselves out, 100,000 acres were gone. It's Yellowstone, you know? People don't want to touch it. But we touch it every single day. But hey, I got a 30 cents an hour raise because we can't have another fiasco. Like the goddamn park can burn down again.
I'm gonna be entirely honest, I didn't understand a whole lot of what that conversation was about. All I know is that, okay, Yellowstone being left to burn bad.
So, I have a bit of a confession to make.
What is it?
Look, I was drunk last night when I woke up to the job.
Yeah, well, you're not the first boss to be guilty of that.
I know, I know I can get a little pushy, you know, putting you on the spot about why you're out here and stuff.
And you thought it was a good idea to get into your, love life, I guess you'd call it?
Yeah, anyway, I'm sorry.
It's fine.
It's fine.
I'll keep that sort of a thing to a minimum. Anyway, let me know when you get back to your lookout.
I mean, highly irresponsible, don't get me wrong, but it's fine. Things happen, it's not the end of the world. And it got a laugh out of me, so, hey, there's that. What the heck was that?
Hey, I heard some thunder.
Yeah, I've got eyes on a storm out to the north.
Well, that's bad. Right, because of the lightning?
It just means we'll be busy. Hurry home, and try not to get hit by lightning.
Sure.
I got hit by lightning when I was 9 years old, so I'm safe. It's not gonna strike twice and all that.
Well, there was an old lookout named Roy Sullivan who got hit by lightning 7 times.
I don't like the sound of that.
Yeah, well, if it makes you feel any better, it wasn't what killed him.
What killed him?
Suicide. Would you believe?
That's awfully heavy to just drop out of the blue. Good lord. Also, 7 times? I hope that's not true. That is monumentally bad luck. 1, 2, 3, 4. Get the map thing.
There's a horn or an antler or whatever.
Well, antlers are made of bone, and horns are made of the same stuff as your fingernails.
I guess this is a bone.
Antler. A ranger must have found it this spring.
Can I take it with me? Answer is no.
I found a flashlight.
There's one in there? Great. Well, the sun's gonna go down soon, so if the batteries still work, you're in luck.
Okay. How...
What's in this cave down here?
In Thunder Canyon?
Thunder Canyon?
Hey, I didn't name it. But in the cave? I don't know, rocks? NFS tells people not to go too far in there. It's pretty dangerous. So, I say, fuck it. You're a grown man, you can go where you want.
Great. Used to go caving with someone back in Colorado. She loved it. Might be great to explore it sometime this summer.
Well, that could be fun. Obviously, be very careful.
It doesn't seem that dangerous. Whoa, whoa! Ah, no!
Henry!
Seriously, it's completely fine in here.
God damn it!
They're bickering with each other so much. I'm kind of living for it.
Hello? Oh!
What a dork. What is this? For access, key available at Ranger Station Dubois, Wyoming. Hopefully I'm reading that right.
This cave is gated off.
It's to stop spelunkers from dying without getting the keys from the Forest Service office first.
Makes sense.
Although, Debbie says she lost them like 3 years ago, so maybe its mysteries are locked away for good.
Ah, damn.
Yeah, but maybe you can find another one to get your caving kicks in.
Oh, this one's so close to home and convenient, though.
Aw, sorry, Hank.
Hank? Who's Hank? I thought we were Henry. Whoopsie daisy. Yeah, like the time of day is absolutely changing. Oh wow. The game has its little stutters every now and again. I wonder if that's because of loading. Hopefully it just doesn't pull a red door on me. Hello?
There's some guy out here.
Some guy? Wait, he's looking at you? Is he doing anything else?
I don't think so.
Okay, that's creepy.
Henry, there's something something someone should have told you about this area.
What is it?
It's outside.
Come on.
The whole thing. And people come and go as they please. It's madness.
Yeah, okay. I get it.
Look, bumping into someone in the middle of nowhere is part of the fun.
She's so sassy. Oh, that's pretty. Hold on. Thanks for telling me about that. There's so much pretty scenery. What if they're burying bodies? Let's hope not. See, where are we going now? There's a lot of wind going on. So this is where he was standing, I think. Okay, let's not drop down. Seems like a terrible idea. This way, maybe? I guess we're climbing. Whoopsie daisy. Guys, pretty athletic. At least if like he is doing this and remaining relatively like only moderately out of breath from the sounds of it. Okay, wow, there's a lot of climbing here. 3, 4, up. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep. Oh, okay. There he is. Okay, so that's not good.
Well, that trail isn't closed anymore.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I took care of the blocked path. It was backbreaking, but. You know, anything for the service.
Well, thank you.
Anytime.
The amount of sarcasm and sass from every single line. Like, smug, smug, smug. I don't know, I kinda like it. And the delivery is like, the cherry on top of everything.
So it's just the outhouse then, in terms of going to the bathroom?
You're a man, Henry. You can go wherever you want. Well, number one at least. And, full disclosure, I pee wherever I want as well.
Didn't ask, but thank you.
So this generator is all the power I've got out here?
Yep. It doesn't go through much gas, and, well, you don't have much in the way of electronics, so...
What about my hairdryer?
Oh, I'm sorry. You might just have to make peace with frizzy locks.
I could never.
What is?
What can I do for you?
Well, my typewriter is on the ground, outside of my tower.
You write?
Yeah, look, the wind? No. How the hell
You should get inside.
Fuck me.
Okay, this is not good.
Someone broke in.
They what?
They wrecked the place. Threw my typewriter out the window. Motherfucker!
Holy shit. I'll let the Forest Service know what happened.
Okay. I would assume it's that dude, but why? In the middle of nowhere?
I'm gonna have to fix the window.
Tomorrow, Henry. You won't be cold. Okay, I put in a call.
That was fast.
That was fast.
Yeah, well, do you have any idea who could have done this?
Maybe that guy I saw in the canyon, but I don't know why the fuck he'd want to mess with my stuff.
Well, I'll have the rangers keep an eye out for a man hiking on his own and question him if they find him.
The girls were jerks, but I don't think that they would do this. They just seemed like teenagers.
And fires, and that's about it. And now I've got to worry about some deranged hiker going after lookouts? Great. Okay, in the morning I'm gonna call my friend Patty, who works the desk down in Cody. They keep a list of everyone who's officially been in and out of the trailhead since, I don't know, forever, and see if we can get a list of names. We won't get much, but at least if anything else happens, we can refer to it and see if anything comes up.
Thanks.
I need you to feel safe out here.
Don't worry
about it.
Oh, you can protect yourself, huh?
I've done it before.
Okay, tough guy.
I didn't know that was gonna go the creepy route. That was kind of unnerving.
Wake up!
We're awake.
Hey, wake up!
Oh, good first day. Achievement unlocked.
I'm awake. What's your problem?
Our problem.
Sorry, our problem.
That storm knocked out the phone line I used to talk to the service, which means we're cut off. I tried radioing out, and that's not working either.
Can I go fix it?
I don't know why that would be the case.
Can I go fix it?
Well, you probably can't, but what you can do is hike out to where the wire runs through your area and report back if it's down. Then I can track down a ranger to get someone on it.
Okay, I can do that. Where is it?
Remember that cave you hiked through yesterday?
Yeah, of course.
So you're gonna want to go back there, go through it, and keep going straight to the north when you come out.
Will do.
Thanks, Hank.
Why Hank? I don't...
It's Henry.
What, you don't like Hank?
Yeah, I don't like Hank.
But thanks rhymes with Hank.
No, it doesn't.
Okay, all right.
Yeah, it really doesn't. I like that we actually get to keep it because we picked it up. Can I drink? Oh, I just straight up take it with me. Okay. I guess you never know when you need some whiskey. There we are. Okay, back to the cave. And then keep going north. Okay, so we came from here, did we not? Yeah, there's the outhouse. Think it was from here, right? And this is where the closed trail was. Right? Yeah, seems like it. Let's drop down here. Doesn't seem dangerous at all. I hope I'm going the right way. My sense of direction is bleh. Parkour, parkour, yeah. Parkour! Is this a horror game? I don't think so. Doesn't seem like one. But I was a little bit freaked out, I will admit.
Oh, it's actually pretty damn cold out here.
Roger that. Warms up fast. The mornings are cold in Boulder, though, right?
Yeah, they are.
What did you get up to down there? I mean, what's life like?
Oh.
I just spend a lot of time with Julia.
Oh, so you have someone there.
Well...
But you're taking a little break, or...
We're...
Look, I'm sorry. Can you hold that thought?
Sure. Just gonna keep hiking and hoping it warms up.
Heyo. I don't think so. Why, have you?
Where are we... What?
Okay, good.
Hey, your button is still down.
No, I don't think he has any idea. I'm absolutely sure. Would you?
What is she talking about? What's she talking about?
All right, I'll let you know if anything changes in that regard. Hey, sorry about that. Anyway, Julia, girlfriend? Ex? Sorry, I don't mean to pry.
That's not important.
That would be my wife, Julia.
Oh, like your wife? Or like she's taken half my stuff wife?
My wife.
But you're here.
She's sick, and I shouldn't be here, but I am.
I'm sorry, Henry. What is it?
We'll get into it.
Okay. Well, in the meantime, you are here, and it's beautiful, and escaping isn't always something bad.
Yeah, sure.
Look, I gotta go do a thing, but I'll have a radio. Okay, call me if you need to.
I think the game freaked out a bit there, because I clicked the gap in the bush, and he just kind of went, whee, off to the left. Like, a lot, like, part of me, when seeing the dialogue options, think it's really fascinating, like, the different ways that you can, like, teeth the conversation. It's like, it's interesting, and part of me is really curious, but I just keep picking the things that I would have picked. Like, if I was in Henry's shoes, like, I feel like Henry would care about Julia, you know? Or at least I want him to care about Julia. Like, that's the most important thing to him. That's what I would want him to think, at least. Instead of thinking about that bar, like, I did not want to pick that. I did not want to pick the bar at all. Oh, wow. Stutters.
I can see the wire you're talking about. It looks like it's in good shape from here.
Well, follow it up to the top of the trail if you can. You can head back as soon as you give me the all clear.
Got it. You wake up pretty early then, huh?
As soon as the sun comes up. Forest Service really frowns on us putting up curtains for some reason.
Can I see her?
I just covered my head with my pillow. Seems to do the trick.
Wow. The forest could never burn down on your watch.
Can you see the communication wires from where you are?
I can see the poles, but I have no idea if the wire is in good shape or not. They run a good distance up to a spot called Beartooth Point. You just need to walk along them all the way up there and make sure everything's in ship shape.
Okay, Beartooth Point, it's this way. Should be this way, right? Unless I'm stupid again. God, this is making me want it to be summer already. I want to do summery things. I want to go hiking. I want to, like, travel places. I want to go swimming, all that stuff. Oh yeah, that's broken, all right. Oh, that's another cache. I should probably check that out.
Guess what?
What is it?
There's a bunch of empty cans up here.
Same as before?
Yep.
These fucking kids.
Why do you think they'd be up here?
Hell if I know, but they better have stayed away from our communication stuff.
Let's take this with us. Maybe it was the girls.
Well, I hopped down a drop, and now I can't climb back up.
That is a pickle.
I can just keep hiking, but I figured I should let you know in case I get myself trapped out here.
How adventurous of you.
I've been doing a lot more climbing out here than I expected.
Well, keep your radio charged. I'd hate to one day find a skeleton with an orange backpack at the bottom of a ravine.
Okay, it doesn't seem that hard to be able to get back.
So we really can't reach anyone any other way than these wires?
What else do you suggest? Smoke signals?
Just seems dangerous.
Well, if they don't hear from me for a few days, they'll send someone out, but I'd rather it not come to that.
Oh no, the fizzy drink. Ah, this was a bad idea. Eh. I wish I could pick that up. I don't want any litter laying around. Oh. What's with the green stuff here? I don't get that.
Okay, the wire's down here.
Okay, good. Any sign of those girls? Did they mess with anything?
I'll look around.
Huh.
Hey, so the wire is definitely down out here. I just found it. Yeah, the thing is, it doesn't look like the wind. It looks like it was cut deliberately.
I knew it. The moment you said you found their trash. These idiots are gonna pay. Do they realize this is how people die? I mean, what if something happened to one of my lookouts while this was going on? And God forbid,
oh, it is
actual
them.
Fire burning out of control.
What do you want to do?
What the hell? What kind of kids
them.
Is this?
And then what?
I haven't thought that far ahead. That's not true. Everything that comes to mind is illegal.
Let's hear it.
Oh yeah?
Hey, I came out here for a breath of fresh air and some adventure. What do you got?
I think I want you to just find them and scare the hell out of them.
Yeah, I'd make a spooky ghost costume, but they stole my sheets.
I don't know. Wait for them to wander off and wreck their camp. Something that would make a teenage girl run home to mommy and daddy.
I'll find them.
Thanks.
But I am gonna need a raise.
Don't hold your breath. I'd start by hiking back towards your tower and just keep an eye out for anything that would lead you to them.
Well, they're big into Red Eagle.
Great. See if you can find the path they took down from there. Maybe they looped back around towards the lake or something.
Maybe?
I doubt they're where they were yesterday, but they obviously can't have gone far.
I guess I just follow the beer cans? That would be the logical thing. Also, like, what the heck kind of mindset is that? You get told off by somebody who is like, whose job it is to look after the area when you're being a complete idiot, and you break into their watchtower, you steal their stuff, and then you just go and sabotage the methods of communication? Or like, are you serious? What kind of kids are these? Good lord. See, is it starting to make sense why I picked, like, there's no rush with kids earlier? What is this?
There's an abandoned pack out here.
And it's not one of the teens?
No, it looks like it was lost a long time ago.
Well, you could always pilfer it for supplies.
Can I? Oh, I can.
Brian Goodwin.
A dare.
Well, I am flush with ropes now. That pack was full of them, in decent condition, too.
Cool.
That's lucky.
I mean, there's enough rope here that I could just leave them hooked up, I think. Oh, get this. This pack came with one of those cardboard single-use cameras.
With pictures left?
Yeah, he only used 3 or 4.
Neato.
Thank you, Brian Goodwin.
Wait, who?
The bag had the name Brian Goodwin sewn into the top.
Huh. Wow.
Do you know him?
Yeah, I just haven't heard that name in a few years.
I'm morbidly curious.
What, was he a fella you had a thing with?
Yeah, it was so hot and heavy. Of course, Brian Goodwin was 12 years old, so...
Okay, never mind. Backpedal.
Ugh. I'm kidding. Not about him being an actual 12-year-old. That part's true. He was stationed in Two Forks, your lookout, with his dad Ned 3 summers ago. Great kid.
You can bring children out here?
No. You know, I'm not a stickler for rules. They took off halfway through the summer.
Is Ned that guy from the note I told you about? About the guy leaving his post?
Could be, yeah. But I think at one point they just realized this job wasn't for them. Hmm. For Brian, at least.
Huh.
Anyway, so it goes. Have fun with that camera. Try not to snap anything that would scar a photo dome employee.
I don't know. I got a lot of hiking to do. Might get bored.
Well, I'm bored as rocks, so I'll keep you company while you find those girls, huh?
Okay, so I'm having a lot of trouble, like, keeping up with things. Okay, so far, we've gotten out here. There was those teens that sabotaged a bunch of stuff. There's a dude roaming around. There was a break-in. We're not sure if it's the girls, but it's likely. And then something about a Brian Goodwin, which apparently is connected to the dude leaving the notes. It just seems like a bunch of unconnected dots at this point. I'm having a hard time, like, threading a, like, connecting them or, like, finding some sort of red thread. Maybe that's just me being stupid. My brain is not very good. Let's see.
Hey, who are these guys, Ron and Dave? They're leaving notes for each other in the boxes. Is there any chance one of them was that guy I saw in the canyon? You know, the guy with the flashlight?
No, they're both rangers. They're not out here this season. I didn't really know them that well, but I always assumed the only thing Ron cared about was chasing tail and getting loaded. It's somehow comforting to know that he was able to keep up a correspondence with someone who wasn't going to send him a topless Polaroid.
Dave, guess who's going out with Debbie next week? No, not that shitheel Steve. It's your man Ron. I went up to check on the new guy at Two Forks and heard him talking to himself, more than usual for LOs, whatever that means. So I figured I'd stay away. Remember when you saw Chimney Rock having himself in that hammock? I'm starting to think the Forest Service only picks the deranged and perverted. Except for us, of course. We're the creme de la creme. Let's toast Deb at the spot, Ron. What are they talking about? I can't tell if I'm stupid for, like, not being able to keep up with this.
Someone found a fossil and put it in a cash box.
Could be the same person who left that antler.
Maybe they're leaving me an entire creature, piece by piece.
That would be terribly morbid, so let's not hope. Let's hope not. Blah, English. What the heck is that?
I see a really thin plume of smoke.
Yeah, I see it too. A thin plume like this is either a new fire or a campfire.
Campfire? You think it's them?
I reckon so.
It looks like it's to the southwest of me.
That's right. If you hike towards 5 Mile Creek, that should put you in the neighborhood.
Hey.
Keep an eye on that smoke plume. Let me know if it's getting any larger.
Will do.
Let's go scare the shit out of some brats, shall we? I mean, what kind of, like, how have you been brought up?
I had a hell of a time getting this fucking flapjack off his ass and out to repair that wire.
Okay, wow. I mean, how are you raised if you think that this kind of stuff is okay and, like, you're entitled to it?
Excuse me, flapjack?
You know, like a loser, a chotch.
I really don't, but I do now.
Well, the next time you're at a bar and some banker steps on your foot so he can order his crappy martini, you've got just the name to use.
Hey, flapjack, why don't you wait your turn before I bounce your face off a dumpster?
It's beautiful!
They're so excited. That's how Karens are made? Oh yeah, that might be a good point. Yeah, that's getting closer. Let's hope this one doesn't break, because this looks like a steep fall. Thank you for the soup, go spook some kids! Let's spook some kids! Yoink. Just kind of like clicks that in like it's nothing. It's kind of satisfying, but not very realistic. Ooga booga! I'm gonna channel my inner Enna Senpai.
What does she have?
What? Oh.
She's got Alzheimer's. Like, dementia.
Whoa. How old was she?
Is she? She's alive. She's with her family in Melbourne, Australia. She's 43.
Fuck.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What was it like when you guys found out?
Devastating. Especially for her. You can understand.
And for you.
Anyway, everything she worked for was taken away, and that was it. Yeah. I'm sorry to be such a downer.
Don't even. I'm happy to listen. And, aww, you know, we'll try to have some fun this summer. I promise.
Having somebody to talk to, or like, just to listen to you can be... can make such a difference. It's like... I know that some people are a little bit apprehensive to listening to, like, heavy personal problems because... they might be fixers, if you guys know what that is. Where people, essentially when they hear that somebody is, talking about their frustrations or, like, their qualms, they're looking for somebody to help them. Which is not always the case. Sometimes they just want to be heard out. And not necessarily, it feels better than screaming into the void, you know? It's like when the few times that like I will talk to somebody about something that might be weighing me down, more often than not, I'm not looking for them to solve my problems. Like that's not their responsibility. But I will say that it does feel a lot better than just yelling into nothingness or pouring my heart out on paper that'll just end up in the trash. I think it's a good thing to be able to talk about stuff like that. It's like that expression, it's better to not to get those things out than to keep them bottled up, you know? Better out than in. Okay, let's see. Where are we heading? Where's that smoke? Kind of lost track of it. I hope I'm going the right way. Oh my god. Music is so peaceful. Oh, there it is. Thank you.
how'd you meet?
Oh.
Met in a bar.
The birthplace of modern romance.
I walked over and asked her what her major was because I thought she was a student, not a prof.
Smooth.
That's me. I did make the first move, though.
Aw, you were brave.
I was drunk.
I like that it remembers what we answered. Gee, where am I going? Oh, compass. Here we are. Where am I? Oh, there. Okay, so over there. So I guess... how do we get over there? I guess I can turn right around, right before Shitty Boss is gonna get me killed hill. Which is a sentence that is somehow correct. So yeah, getting lost in the woods with me would be a bad idea. That's the name of the story. Or, the moral of the story. Ah, see, this is what I was looking for. Let me just double check. Yeah, this is it. Here we are. Let's go down here. I'm so glad that a lot of the dialogue is like... Or not a lot of the dialogue. All the dialogue is like so excellently voiced. It lets me rest my voice a little bit. I'm fine with reading the notes though. That's fine. Oh, it's so peaceful. It's like borderline ASMR. Like I could probably just... like walk around in this game and just relax. Oh my god, hold on, that's pretty. Hold on a second. There we are. I have a great sense of direction, so I'll keep you safe on a hike. Thank you for the super. I'll leave it to you guys then. If I'm ever lost, I'll just rely on the Quildren.
Boy, for as dry as it is this summer, there's an area down here that's lush.
Oh, you must be talking about the Aspen Grove down there.
Yeah, I think that's where I am.
Those trees are actually one root organism. Did you know that?
I didn't.
Yeah, they share their water as a colony that can live for hundreds of years, even through fire. Can you believe you're actually getting paid to learn all of these amazing things? Also, by what it looks like on this map, you'll be coming up on a stream that should lead you towards where we saw that smoke.
Yep, that'll be this one, I guess. Hold on a second. What the hell? Oh, I can take, like, in-game pictures? Cool. They knew their game was pretty.
What are you gonna do when the fire season wraps up? Are you gonna go be with her? Just go back to Boulder? You should go be with her. That's
yeah.
My opinion. Sorry for the umpteenth time.
Maybe I'll go visit. I don't know.
Well, why not?
She's with her family in Melbourne. They're not big fans of mine.
Oh.
Her sister, Susan, is great, but her parents... I think they always thought she could do better. And that I could have done a better job looking after her.
Fuck that. I have no doubt you did your best.
I don't know.
If you want to go visit her, you should go. Don't let a couple of assholes keep you away from someone you love.
I'll think about it.
I mean, he did do some stupid things, but... he's human, you know?
It's a really nice waterfall down here. Given those girls love a skinny dipping, I bet they're nearby.
What is this?
There's some cloth out here. It looks like it was torn from something.
Strange.
I'll keep looking around.
Thank you very much for the sofa.
Where are we going now? I guess over there? Am I going the right way? I don't think I am. Over here, maybe? Oh, there we are.
I see a campsite, and it looks like they've got a fire.
Is it them?
That seems like it. I swear, they must have dragged 4 cases of beer out here.
Track them down, and don't let them see you.
What a job this is.
Stomp this thing out.
These girls have a full case of beer left here. A full case.
Well, they're impressive little shits, I guess.
That is some dedication.
Can we take it? Oh, that sucks.
Well, I found some dangerous hunks.
What on earth are you...
It's the name of a magazine for girls. It's on the ground here at their camp.
Dangerous hunks.
I don't get why the hunks have to be so dangerous.
Well, you're clearly not a young woman.
Girls should want nice hunks.
Ugh, boring.
Oh my god, this sounds exactly like certain people I know. I will not name them. If you're watching, you know who you are.
I have entered the teen zone.
Oh, really? And where's that?
It's another one of those magazines. Pants are back.
I'm sorry, pants are back?
Well, according to the experts at Teen Zone magazine, it's unclear where they've been. The pants, I mean?
Why does everybody think that it's Alira Senpai?
Ah, found my sheets!
So they did break into your tower.
Looks like.
I mean, I'm not gonna say if you're right or wrong, but... I don't know. It's not a bad guess. I could see that. Disclaimer, this is purely my own speculation and my own opinions and does not reflect the actuality of reality.
Their tent looks like it's been through the shredder. Which
Christ.
Would explain that scrap I found.
What could have done that? Like a bear or, I don't know, it sounds crazy, but even a bull elk if it's off its rocker.
Whatever did it, did not hold back.
You've got that camera, right? It might be a good idea to get a few snaps, just in case.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, good thinking.
Okay. Okay, nice.
Some of their clothes are all torn up.
That's not good.
Oh, boy. Is there anything else?
You know, maybe I should take one of their sleeping bags as payback.
At this stage, take whatever you want.
It doesn't let me take anything, though.
Looks like someone left a note.
Intriguing. Maybe you should read it.
Okay, yeah.
Let me know what it says.
Dear Psycho, hope you're fucking happy. We're leaving, and we're going to find the police or whatever and tell them about how you creeped on us in the lake and then came and destroyed our campsite and all of our stuff. Oh, and stealing panties is gross out. You're probably a mental fucking axe murderer and are so going to jail. I hope it was worth being a jerk over some fireworks, dick. Heart. The way that they're writing just infuriates me. It's like the worst kind of people that I can imagine. But we didn't destroy anything, so that was somebody else.
Oh, they're gone, for sure.
Well, what's it say?
Why would I say that?
Threatening to call the police because they think I attacked them.
Oh my god, well, did you?
No, well, hey, I didn't do this, okay? Someone or something went to town here, but it wasn't me.
Because I told you to scare them, not assault them.
Yeah, I took their whiskey back at the lake, but that just felt like, I don't know, the cost of doing business.
That's different, okay? And I don't blame you.
This is, I don't know, weird as hell, but it wasn't me.
It's okay. I believe you. Weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know, but they're gone. There's no way to call the cops. They're not coming back, and we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Yeah, me too.
Isn't that the whole thing, the reason that, oh, that people are coming out here? Thank you very much for the Akaspa. Let me just read that Akaspa real quick. Von Peterov, thank you very much. As someone who hasn't played any video games in about a decade, I'm grateful to you for introducing me to a whole bunch of intriguing games I had no idea existed. Well, thank you. I'm glad that I'm able to introduce you to some new games you haven't heard of before. It's always exciting to find something new and exciting that just happens to, like,
hey, Henry?
Be aligned with your tastes, you know?
Yeah.
What do you look like?
Why are you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
Oh my god, thank you for the
Akaspa.
And the Akachad. Thank you very much. It says nothing.
And
your name is just like an underscore.
I could be Tom Cruise's good-looking twin brother.
Oh, that's too bad. I read in People he's like 5 foot nothing.
Yeah, well, you can't win them all.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, you know, PC or whatever they say.
Sorry. Hanabi, thank you very much for the Akaspa. Aiku, おやすみなさい。Thank you very much for the Akaspa. I hope you sleep well.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. Wow. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear?
I don't really think about it, or I try to...
This can't be that hard.
I don't know. I like to look nice, usually. Well, I try now, I guess.
Had a bit of a schlubby period, did we?
Yeah, schlubby. A good 25, 30 years, yeah.
But, now you'll put on a clean shirt?
Yeah, well, I have one that I got for Christmas, actually. Just, it's navy with white buttons, but I like it. I don't wear it that much, though.
Well, it sounds just perfect. Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
He had a beard, didn't he?
I know it's not easy.
A pretty thick beard.
Oh, have you always had a beard?
For a while, yeah.
All right, perfect. I want to know about your eyes.
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
You're what?
Is that okay? Don't answer. I'm going to do it regardless.
Okay.
Fine.
Your eyes, tell me.
What does steely mean? Tired, I guess?
They look tired, I think.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you know, you hit a certain age and you think you're a younger person who just looks tired all the time.
Speak for yourself, mister.
But I guess that's getting old.
Well, some people might see distinguished. Okay, got it. Thank you, Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.
That was kind of weird. Oh, I can turn on a flashlight. I did not know that. Can I put this back? I guess that'll work. That works. Can I bring the whiskey with me again? The answer is yes. Bring the whiskey wherever. So what am I doing now? I forgot. What is my objective? Find boards downstairs. Okay. There we are. Do we have any boards? Yes, we do. Okay, more boards. More boards. Is there another board? There has to be. Board. There it is. Let's go board up the broken window. I almost said let's go broke up the boarded window. Are we searching for Bigfoot at this point? Now that would be something, wouldn't it? Bonk, bonk. Man's hits a nail like a pro. Like one hit on each of them, just like bam, 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 bam.
I got that window all patched up. So what should I do now? What's next?
What's next? What do you think is next?
Well, you've been the one giving me tasks for 2 days straight.
What's next is you sit in that room until September 1st and call me at the first sign of smoke.
Oh, yeah.
Why don't you let me know when you're mentally prepared for that task, and I'll give it to you.
Okay, I think I am ready to tackle my long-term commitment of keeping this national forest safe from total destruction.
I am glad to hear you've really thought this through.
Of course.
We've issued you a comfy chair to sit in and everything.
You know, it's not really that comfy. It's wooden and there's no padding. I think I actually got a splinter in my thigh this morning.
Aww. Well, regardless, take a seat. The forest depends on you.
Oh, day 9. We're skipping a few. Sandwich.
Hello, Henry. Having a nice afternoon?
Yeah.
Not too bad. I could get used to it out here.
That's nice. Look, I called with bad news. 2 young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing. We've got parents out in California who haven't heard from them in a week. They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
Happy to be questioned, I guess?
You should tell whoever that I'm happy to be questioned.
Look, it's not gonna be an issue. If they turn up dead, then maybe...
Good lord, let's not think
should
like
I
that.
Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble?
Yeah, it's worth mentioning, like...
I think it's worth mentioning something.
Yeah, I'll keep it vague. I really don't want to talk to the cops.
Me neither.
All right, Henry, thanks. Enjoy the sunset.
Oh, I didn't get a chance. I was waiting for the screen to clear. Oh, that sucks, man. Oh well.
Henry, wake up.
Oh boy.
Get out of bed and pick up the radio.
What time is it? Oh, it's broken.
What do you want?
Hey, you big dumb idiot.
What? Is this actually Julia?
Hi, Jules.
Oh, you sound tired.
Oh, it is.
Are you having a nice time?
Oh, this is a dream, isn't it?
Sure. Are you? Everything good there? Jules?
What? Oh, sorry, Henry. Yeah, I'm good.
Well, that's good.
Well, I'll let you get back to sleep then.
Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Mm-hmm, sure.
Bye, baby.
No, this is not a dream. I think that was Delilah and he was just too tired to realize, and she realized and just didn't tell him. Not sure how I feel about that.
Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair? Anyway, when you find the supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more.
Fair enough.
There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky.
Beans!
My sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6. She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function.
Okay. Oh, this also looks kind of pretty. Hold on.
So, like, 2 weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night? You were sleeping, I guess, and...
I knew it!
All I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles. I just thought it was so sweet. I wanted to wake you up, but then I thought maybe you were having a nice conversation, and I'd just be spoiling it. I hope you're doing okay, you know, when it comes to her.
You really shouldn't, my dude.
I shouldn't be out here.
Yes, you should.
No, I just ran away from my problems.
No, you didn't. We all fuck up. Look. So, a couple of months before I took this job, I was with this guy, Javier. Ugh, he's incredible, caring, sexy as hell. He was a driller down in Casper. We dated for almost 5 years. I was working with the Wyoming Outdoor Leadership School, and I was obsessed with it. I wanted to be an instructor so badly. And I was sure I was going to marry Javier as soon as I could be bothered. Walls was also a good excuse to get out of town, drink whiskey in the mountains, cut loose. Then, Javier's brother got killed working in Gillette, and for some reason, I didn't come home. Javier said it was fine. He'd go to the funeral, take care of his mom, stuff like that. It'd be easier solo. When he came back, he left me. I came out here. I lied and told my sister he fucked our neighbor.
This is a lot coming right out of nowhere.
Over 10 years.
I didn't. Sorry, I hate to be mean, but I didn't ask.
I wanted you to know. I figured you've told me so much about you, so, you know, there's something about me. We both fucked up.
Okay, I realize that, like, I'm being a little bit of a hypocrite considering what I said earlier. Like, it's nice to be, like, talk about your problems, and that can be really healthy. But Delilah asked Henry, and he chose to open up. And I had the option to dodge it. Unless I missed something, I didn't ask about any of that. I mean, I hope that she feels better, like, having spoken up about it, but it was kind of out of nowhere, and it caught me off guard a little bit. I don't mean to sound insensitive. Oh man, I feel like a jerk now. Like, that was probably, like, really, like, important to her to talk about, but it just caught me off guard, you know? I wouldn't have minded, like, hearing that out if I was just a little bit more prepared, I guess, if that makes sense. Don't care, didn't ask? No. Like, it's not don't care. Like, it's not don't care, didn't ask. That's, like, terribly mean. in this instance. I do care, like... But it's just... I'm the kind of person that sort of... I get caught off guard easily. If somebody wants, like, somebody to lend an ear, then I'm more than happy to do so. But I just gotta be ready for it. If it just drops on me out of nowhere, my brain sort of shuts down and I don't know what to say. And that's sort of what happened there. It was just very sudden, I guess. If I would have, like, if I knew that it was coming, then I would have been more than happy to listen to what Delilah had to say. Oh, is this it?
Found the supplies.
Oh, good. Enjoy.
Supplies, motherfucker. Let's see. Two forks, that's us.
All right. I got everything I need out of here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Who do you think I am?
Yeah, exactly. 64?
Oh. You've got a front row seat for what might be the biggest fire of the year.
Yeah, it's really going.
Oh, wow.
I'm gonna call it in. They'll send in a hotshot crew for some suppression, but I bet we'll be stuck with her for the rest of the summer. And she doesn't have a name yet. I usually think of something funny or something practical or a little risque when coming up with them. But why don't you do the honors? So, no ideas, huh?
That's lame. That's a little bit...
Come on, there's gotta be something creative in that brain of yours.
Do we go flapjack? Yeah, let's go flapjack.
You're in one of your quiet moods.
Maybe we call it the flapjack fire. Can you sell that as a name?
You really like that, huh?
Yeah, I said I did. It's funny.
Fair enough. Flapjack fire it is.
Oh, hey, it changes.
It was a camp cooking accident or something.
What happened to those girls? Good question.
And, you know what my favorite thing to do is?
What's that?
I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day. And then, on nights like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot, I have something nice and cool to drink. I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe. She'd do that with a bottle of tequila near her house and make margaritas the size of your head. You'd like it there.
Yeah, no.
I've had one too many bad experiences with tequila. I'm a little reticent to try it again.
Well, maybe you just need a new, good experience with it.
Yeah, maybe.
What does that mean?
Are you looking at the fire?
No, I'm not.
You should. Let me know when you are.
Okay, I'm looking at it again.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke, but when the sun is down, you can just get lost.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're here.
Why do you say that?
Because I do. I'm not crazy. I mean, we've had such a good time, right?
This is the only
Yeah, I think so.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you. Not in the same way. And I know you're not really available, but...
Yeah!
I want you to know, well, maybe it'd be nice to get together at the end of the summer. Look, we don't have to plan or even talk about it. I'm just having the thought. I wish I was over there. It'd be nice to be near somebody.
No!
We could talk without these radios. We could...
What is going on?
You know...
No!
It'd be nice to be close to someone. Why don't we both just go watch this fire and try to imagine all the old dead.
Is she drunk? Has she been drinking? Okay. Then like that.
It's one fish, and I'm sick of all the stuff I got to eat.
Well, I won't tell anyone you're a poacher.
Yeah, bring out the stop emotes. Good. What the heck was that?
Trying to keep tabs on. Can you search around the lake for fresh tracks and just let me know what you find? There was a crew burning fire lines out to the east, and you know, I think sometimes it riles up the wildlife.
Problem bear? Fuck. Sherpa.
Problem bear? Fuck that. I am of the opinion that they are all problems.
Come on, please.
Ugh. Can't believe I'm gonna leave this planet as a pile of bear shit.
Thank you, Henry.
Yeah.
Oh, the voice acting is great. I will be just one moment. I need to get another drink because my throat is feeling a little bit parched. I will be right back. ちょっと喉が渇いていたので、ちょっと飲み物を探してみます。ちょっと休憩します。あー。And we're back. Hello. I realized I didn't mute. Sorry about that. It's okay. We're fine. Tadaima. Okie dokie. Let's continue this, shall we? I hope that doesn't happen again. That was weird. That was really weird. And I don't want to deal with it again. Where are we going now again? I need one of those caps. And it's just like fish fear me. Oh. Whiskey. Bring that with us. Why is it that you can bring whiskey with you everywhere for some reason? Like, I don't get that. Like, what's the deal? I guess the whole argument, like, is that there's never a bad time for whiskey? Okay. Yeah. What is that noise? Oh, okay. Do I not get to fish? Come on. Oh, what's this?
Someone left their clipboard out here.
Huh. It could have been one of the fish and game folks. See if there's a name or a credential or something. I can call it in.
What? It's... Holy shit.
What's going on? You didn't actually find a bear, did you?
Someone has written down what we said to each other, have been saying.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
What the heck is going on?
I'm worried. You didn't find and eat any mushrooms, did you? I mean, they can be fun, but also, you know, devastating. Regardless, just let me know, okay, Buckaroo? Oh, God. I don't know why.
I found a walkie-talkie out here, too.
Okay.
It's going shithouse.
Well, get it if you haven't already, and then we'll figure out whose it is.
Will do.
Okay, that's really creepy.
Yeah!
Henry? Are you there? What happened, Henry?
I got hit in the head. Punched or something by someone.
Are you serious? What the hell is going on out there?
Jesus.
I don't know. Jesus Christ.
Let me get this straight. You found a clipboard with, what, transcripts of our conversations? What else is on it?
I don't know. It's gone, along with a radio of theirs. You know, somebody out here could have just killed me, Delilah.
I don't... What the fuck is going on?
What's Wapiti Station?
I don't know.
I saw the name Wapiti Station right before I was cold cocked. Does Wapiti Station mean anything to you?
Wapiti Meadow. Maybe it's Wapiti Meadow. It's on our maps. It's not too far from where you are right now. It's
where?
North of the lake. It looks like there should be a trail somewhere on the north shore of Jonesy Lake.
I'll start hiking that way now. God damn it, my head.
Are you sure you saw what you saw, Henry? Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you.
There are people listening to our conversations. The person or these people were hiding in the bushes down here. What the fuck, Dee?
I don't know, Henry. This sounds...
Why is she being so dismissive? This is incredibly suspicious.
You're not the one who just saw our words on a clipboard out in the middle of nowhere.
Those words were from 2 weeks ago.
I know they were. So what's to say that they don't have transcripts from 3, 4, or 5 weeks ago?
Our entire relationship, friendship, our whole summer.
Someone is out here with the walkie-talkie, taking notes and talking to God knows who. What the hell do you think is going on at this place?
Well, what is this? Who and for what purpose? We're just looking at fires, right?
Yeah, you're telling me. All right, I'm on my way to Wapiti Meadow. I'll let you know what I find.
Okay. There's got to be a reasonable explanation. Also, I'm gonna call around and see if anyone's had anything weird happen to them or seemed spooked. I don't want to make this bigger than it is yet, you know?
Yeah, understood.
Yeah, okay. Hike safe.
Whoa, Delilah, there's a big chain-link fence between me and the meadow.
Why is it...
I don't think I can get past it.
Fenced off?
A fence?
Yeah.
How big?
Big. It goes off in both directions. Acres.
But what the fuck is going on out here?
Whatever it is, someone doesn't want anyone to know about it.
Yeah, what? Like what is happening?
Maybe they've got aliens. That'd be exciting.
Yeah, we'll see about that.
Wapiti.
And what are the odds they left the gate unlocked?
Pretty low, I'd imagine.
Okay, I did not see this story going in this direction. So far, I thought it was just like a very, like... personal character study kind of deal. But now, what is going on? It's like a whole mystery, actually. Oh, no. Sorry.
Okay. I've given it the good college try. No dice.
Shit.
I don't know how long I can dick around out here until someone notices.
If you were an actual firefighter, you'd have that gate down in 2 shakes. Hey, actually, those guys doing the controlled burn, they might be able to help.
That's not funny.
Beyond Ruby River, there's a scout camp. They burned a line a few days ago that should let you hike right to them.
Well, that's great.
If they haven't left, they're probably the type of guys who would help you get through that fence.
Okay. Look for controlled burn south of Ruby River. Okay, where is that? Blue Stone? Wait, can I... Oh, that doesn't work. Really? Oh, that's so... I thought I was onto something. Please? Come on. Ah! This guy sucks. He's barely even hitting it. Where am I going? There's a gate here. Camp for smoke, that's over there. Two forks. Scout camp. Where's the control burn? South of Ruby River. Where's Ruby River? Ruby River. Lake there. Thunder Canyon. Okay, Ruby River. I guess there? Medicine wheel. Okay, I guess go check that out. It's quite a walk, though. And I'm really curious about what is going on. Man, everything was so relaxing earlier. I felt like I was just, like, walking and talking. Walkie-talkie, if you... but it's witty, you see. But now... Even though it's, like, broad daylight with all this beautiful scenery, I feel... uneasy. I think it's in this direction. Let's have a look at the map. Okay, I guess we turn right here. It's not a dad joke, it's just a fun pun. Oh my god, Dean, thank you very much for the Akaspa. Pat Pat, thank you for the head pats. Head pats all around, head pats for everybody. Where am I going? Where am I? What am I doing? Aw, oh, look at the spam of the head pats. This, oh, I love it when that happens. You guys are the best. Music is calming yet foreboding somehow. Oh yeah, the rope broke there. Ah, crap. I guess I have to go this way. I feel like I need to go and, like, place ropes down wherever, like, there's, like, opportunity to do so. So I can go both ways if I need to. Thank you for the super. I like the pronunciation. I like your pronunciation of English. Oh, thank you. My pronunciation does get a little bit weird sometimes, though. So I'm sorry if that happens. Where am I? I'm going the wrong way. Can't go there. So I have to go through Thunder Canyon. Oh my god. Oh, my sense of direction. Just give me three swords, why don't you? I'll have one in my mouth. Then at least my bad sense of direction is gonna make sense.
What does that mean? If you know, you know. Okay, so that is... No, wait!
Hey, I called around. Things seem normal with everyone else.
Okay,
Should we call the cops or the Forest Service and let them know this is going on?
Don't you think that would sound, you know, crazy?
Yeah, it is crazy. We have to tell someone.
Tell them what, Henry? Tell them we're being stalked and you were attacked and we don't have any proof?
I don't know. Tell them we're being bothered or something.
Henry, I really like...
I feel like harassment and assault is kind of valid to...
Cuckoo to my bosses.
What?
They're never gonna let me come back out here. Do you understand that?
All right. I'm headed toward the camp anyway.
Okay. Keep your radio close to you.
Hey, what you just said, keep my radio close to me.
Yeah?
Before I got attacked back at the lake, I saw a radio on the ground, kind of like the one I use.
And?
Do you think that maybe someone was, you know,
I don't know. What?
Maybe intercepting our frequency with other radios or something.
Henry...
It's just a thought.
Oh, there's a bot? Hold on. Oh, there. Sorry about that. They have been bonked.
I don't even know how you would do that.
Yeah, well, you sound worried.
No. I'm not, okay? Let's not spin out of control. Just keep hiking.
Whatever you say, boss.
I don't want to suspect Delilah, but... she's being incredibly dismissive about everything.
I know we don't know what's going on yet, but I don't have a good feeling. I don't like feeling vulnerable. It's not like you can just call the police. I was thinking about the Goodwins. It just struck me that if anything weird like this happened to them, happened to Brian, just how scared he would have been.
He had his dad to protect him. Ned, right?
Yeah.
You don't think he could?
No, you're probably right.
It was 3 years ago. He's in high school now. He's on summer break.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Am I going the right way? Where am I? Oh, okay. I think I'm going the right way. Maybe? Yeah. It has to be this way, right?
Wow, there's an old, I think it's called a medicine wheel out here.
Yeah, it was made by Crow American Indians hundreds of years ago. There are lots of small ones. Have you ever been to Medicine Wheel Monument over in the Bighorns?
I sure haven't.
Well, it's worth a 3-hour detour on the way home in August.
Neat. I'll keep it in mind.
I learned something. It's kind of peaceful.
I found where they did the controlled burn. I can hike right through here now.
Yeah, normally they wouldn't do that so close to a body of water, but I think they're extra worried about a fire jumping the river and burning up to Two Forks now that there's someone in it.
Well, I'm extra appreciative of that.
Let's see. The scout camp is southeast of the river. There should be a pond on the way.
Got it. What happens if a controlled burn gets out of control?
Someone gets fired.
Ugh, are you serious?
Oh, come on. That one was an honest accident. I'm not even in the mood for wordplay. That's how wound up all this shit has me.
Oh. I didn't even realize the pun. Uki is here? Wait, hold on. What did Uki say? Uki, Uki, Uki. Hold on a second. That's not Uki. There's an imposter. Boom, 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 boom. It's not the real Uki, guys. all of Noctix are modded. So, if you don't see a wrench next to their name, it's not them. You can get some attention by pretending to be one of my kohais? Nah. We think ahead here. We're smart cookies. Okay, let's see. Where are we going? I'm living for this music. What the heck just happened? Okay, that is really weird. Hold on. Hmm, that's awfully strange. Is the stream still going? So there was some like error that happened with OBS. And I'm kind of scared of like clicking on anything because I feel like it's gonna crash. I'm terribly sorry about that. But if the stream is still going, then I guess I'll just ignore it. I won't be able to see chat though, which does make me a little bit sad. Hold on, let me try something real quick. Let me try something. If I close this, open that. Open this. Okay, so we have that. Move that. Get that there. Okay, I have you guys back on my screen now. Okay, I guess save the game? Okay, so even though I got an error, I'm a little bit worried about a crash. Apparently it was something with, like, not entirely sure what, but it was something about OBS. But if it's still working, then I guess we keep going. But if I vanish, you guys know what happened, and if that happens, sit tight, and I will be right back if it does.
Snowmobiles out here.
That's crazy.
Looks like one of the poor bastards was cruising across this pond and dumped it.
That was not a fun hike back to civilization.
I can imagine.
Whoa, someone stripped these snowmobiles down to the bone.
Huh.
I mean, that's weird, right?
Hmm.
I mean, I can come up with a bunch of not weird reasons someone would do that out here, but given what's happened, yeah. Yeah, that's weird.
Is there another one here?
There's an old pond out here, not much more than a pile of mud. Do you have it on your map?
Yeah, I know where you are.
Yeah? Where am I?
Pork Pond. There used to be a sign up for it, but, well, folks kept stealing it.
Because it's called Pork Pond?
It's a good goddamn name. That sign would look great in a den, or, you know, anywhere.
Pork Pond? How much you want to bet that Delilah's the one that stole it? Arapaho?
Camp Arapaho.
You're there?
Yeah, I am.
It's been out there since the 50s.
I was never really into the idea of the scouts. It's something about men organizing boys around their ideals. Never sat right with me.
Beware weebelos in large numbers.
The bridge to the camp is out.
Damn.
Okay, so I'm gonna walk around here and see if I can find some high ground to get across.
Good plan.
How do we get around here? Anywhere I can jump, maybe? Ooh, wait, that kind of looks... Yeah, but I can't... Really? Direction. My game is stuttering occasionally. I hope that didn't have anything to do with like the OBS crash, because I feel like my computer might be biting the dust. Okay, can't get across here. What do I do then? I feel like I'm being really dumb. Maybe I can jump here, maybe? Yeah. There we are. Let's see. Okay.
You ever talked to any of the scouts?
No, they haven't been out here in a while, and I generally don't have a lot to say to preteens.
Unless it's Brian Goodwin.
Well, if forced, I mean, I can make conversation with anyone. Plus, it was sort of fun to hear about all of his nerdy hobbies.
I mean, he wasn't a scout or a weeblo or whatever?
I got the sense that boy could barely tie his shoes, let alone a clove hitch.
What the hell's a clove hitch?
Yeah, what is that?
Well, it's a knot that you are probably too old and too stubborn to learn. You use it to make rafts and shelters and stuff like that.
Huh. You know how to tie one?
Heck no, I'd make a weeblo do it.
I guess these little shelters are where they keep the weeblos.
For the past 35 years, yeah.
It's kind of a shame to see these places run down.
Yeah, these guys are gone. I found where they were sitting around before getting picked up.
Damn.
What's this?
Hey, Dee, they left something behind. It's like a memo from their boss.
Did it say anything of note?
Next few days, dropping into the thoroughfare on behalf of Dr. Simmons at Wapiti Station.
Wapiti Station?
Holy crap.
Keep reading.
Oh, I just thought I would maybe, you know, stop there, let the mystery percolate.
My mother always said I would meet someone who'd give me a taste of my own medicine.
They're running a research site out there. He was worried about wildfires.
Someone is writing down our conversations. And now we find out there's a research site out here that we don't know about? What are they researching?
How do you not know about this? You've been here for 10 years!
I mean, you and I aren't very interesting.
Us. They're researching us.
You think they're studying you and me?
Yeah, but why?
I do. Yeah, I mean, maybe it's about studying two strangers who talk every day.
Like, if you put someone in isolation with someone else, what they do.
Yeah, that's what I think.
Well, fuck that.
Agreed.
I think we should allow for the possibility that this is all just a big misunderstanding, but... God, if you saw what you said you did... Fuck, Henry.
Yeah, I saw it.
Okay. So what's next?
I'm gonna do a scan for supplies and then figure out a way to get back over that ravine and hike towards the site.
Sounds good. Check in when you can, and keep an eye out for anyone following you.
Okay, nice. We got an axe. That's good.
Guess what?
What you got?
I found an axe back near that camp.
A firefighter left it?
Probably, yeah.
It's got, like, a funny little point.
Sure does.
Okay, that's called a Pulaski. It's standard issue.
Whatever. This Pulaski I found means I can start clearing these trails.
Hi-ya! Here's Henry. Okay, nice. Now we can use these as shortcuts. Bert? Okay, where do we go now? Boppity Meadow. God, that's a walk. We're doing a lot of walking.
Are you there? I had a thought.
Let's hear it.
You heard someone in the bushes.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's assume we're being tailed. Or you are, at least. Where are you right now?
Just on my way back, in and out of trees, in the middle of nowhere.
Do you see anybody?
No, definitely not.
All right, so tell me what you think of this. Did you just cough?
No. Did you just cough?
No.
Oh, fuck. There isn't any way someone, like, another lookout could be on this line, is there?
No. Not without tapping our radios. Get in your tower, shut the door. Don't leave, and don't use your radio. I'll call you. Understand? I will call you.
God, this is scary! What is going on?
Thoroughfare Tower, this is Two Forks calling you for the, 50th time today. The Flapjack Fire continues to move in a southerly fashion. Delilah, for fuck's sake, answer your radio.
Hello, sunshine. Sorry, went out for a little bit. What can I do you for?
I didn't sleep a wink last night, and I've been going crazy for the past 6 hours of sunup. How are you so chipper?
Well, it's a new day. What a day, this day we've been given.
Maybe I am actually asleep right now. Maybe I didn't stay up
Henry,
all night
knowing that
someone is...
Henry, you're an idiot. Your radios are tapped.
Great.
Okay.
By the way, I was wondering if your Flora of the Shoshone info poster was still up inside your tower?
What?
It's just protocol that those stay up. You know, info about your tower, the surrounding tree species, etc.
All right.
Just, you know, have a look at it. Make sure it's in ship shape.
Okay, yeah, it's up. Why are you acting like this?
He's such an idiot! Has he already forgotten?
See the tree in the top row, second from the left?
Sure. It's the,
No. You don't need to tell me, just, internalize it. It's a great tree. And there's an area called, that tree's name in your sector that maybe you should take a midday hike to. Maybe.
Oh. Yeah. Okay. Maybe I...
Oh, he's so dense!
Nothing like an afternoon in the Rockies, I tell ya. Radio me the moment you get there.
It was... so obvious. How was he? Boy, how can you be this dense? I don't get it. Hold on, we're bringing the whiskey.
Whoa, the flapjack fire isn't going anywhere, huh?
No, that's why those guys came out to burn that line. It's at the stage where all we can do is pay attention to it.
They're not gonna try to put it out?
Not yet, apparently.
Okay, where the heck are we heading? It was called... Pork Pond. Lovely. Okay. Fire break. Medicine wheel. Camphor smoke. Trailhead. What am I looking for? Bridgeth Point. Thoroughfare. What was it called again? Lodgepole Pine, was it? Lodgepole. Am I blind?
Which tree am I supposed to internalize again?
Top row, second from the left.
Oh, left, I'm an
Head
idiot.
Head to a place named after that tree, and you'll have a wonderful afternoon.
Cottonwood Creek. Okay, got it. See, even the smart cookie crumbles sometimes. Cottonwood Creek. Let's see. Am I going the right way? Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I am. Okay, so I think this is where we were last time. Or maybe not. I don't really recognize this. Or do I? My sense of direction is messed up, man. Where is this? Well, I don't know where this is, but there's a supply cache. Wait, is this the right place? Did I accidentally? Okay, maybe not. Hup. Parkour! Let's open this. 1, 2, 3. Okay, let's write that down. Ron, really wish the powers that be could issue us radios that didn't suck ass. Most of the time, I'd prefer to keep things to pen and paper, but every once in a while, it'd be nice to get a hold of you right away. My sister keeps leaving me messages at the main office, but I don't think she gets that I took the job so I wouldn't have to deal with her or Mom. I've been sitting at the spot for a while now, thinking about what to say to her. But I'm a quarter way through this bottle of Fifes? Fifes instead? Miss you, Dave. Okay. Huh. Okay. Is that it? I guess that's everything. I think I can get through here, right? Yeah. I can. Okay, let's have another look-see. Okay, so... Turn right here. Right? Yeah. Okay.
A lot of smoke here. Oh, it's because it's close to the fire. Makes sense. What is this tree? Ski? Okay, but why though? Map updated. Big tree. Oh, alright. Am I stupid? I mean, the answer is obviously yes, but... Am I this stupid? Oh, wait, there's a cache over there. Maybe that's the one? That's the one, maybe?
I'm here at Cottonwood Creek.
Oh, you idiot!
You see the cache box there?
Don't say it!
It must be around here somewhere.
It is. Find it and open it. I changed the code. It's 5678.
Are you kidding me?
I was in a rush.
Okay, found the cache box.
Great, open it.
5678. Okay, get that jotted down. And...
Hey, there's a different walkie-talkie in here.
God damn it, Henry.
Oh, this is what you left me.
Yeah. And I was really hoping to keep it a secret. Take
dumbass.
It and chuck the other one, then call me.
Then again, I was the one who picked the dialogue option. Maybe I'm the dumbass.
I've got it now.
Good. I spent all day getting you that radio. I hiked to a cache box, lied to a ranger, lied to another ranger... Hopefully you are now holding a clean, untapped radio.
Hopefully.
Holy fuck, Henry. We have to get into that site.
What the fuck is going on? People are listening to us?
I don't know.
Our radios are tapped? Are you fucking serious?
Yeah, what is happening?
Our radios are definitely tapped. That's why I left you the one you just got.
How is this even possible?
I don't know, Henry.
What do you know?
You know that I'm scared.
Who is doing this?
I don't know who could be doing this. Henry, I've been at this job off and on for 13 years. Sometimes here, sometimes over near Jackson, a couple times down in Wind River. And nothing like this has ever happened before.
Are there any other lookouts this is happening to?
Why is she why is she taking this seriously all of a sudden? She was so dismissive up until this point.
Happening to us.
She like turned on a dime.
Are you sure?
Yes. I've tried to bring it up to Chimney Rock, Elk's Fork, and Beartooth Lookout, and every one of them got confused. Asked me if I'm okay and if I need to be relieved. Our fucking state coordinator asked if I was just having lady troubles. So no. This isn't happening to anyone else, and I'm done asking.
Look, I'm headed back to the gate, and now that I've got an axe, we'll know something soon.
You need to get into that site. Call me when you find something.
Okay. Where are we?
Hey. I just thought of something not great.
Okay.
What is it?
I filed a report that said that neither of us ever talked to or saw those girls, the ones that went missing a few weeks back.
What? Why would you do that? I told you to say the minimum and just keep it vague.
I know. And...
Oh
I
my
didn't.
God!
I just didn't want to be hassled.
And now... Someone probably has a transcript of that entire conversation.
And I've filed a report that's a blatant lie.
Oh, and those girls are still missing.
Yeah, this is gonna look bad if somebody... Yeah, my thoughts exactly.
Fuck, Delilah.
Fuck, indeed. We really need to get to the bottom of this.
What is this? Oh my God. It's terrifying.
I went in the wrong direction like an idiot. Oh well. Let's take the scenic route, shall we? Why is there a generator next to an outhouse? I don't know. I'm assuming it's for the power? Like, there's probably a wire going from the generator up to the top. Directionally challenged, are we, Ike? Always! Outhouses don't use power, though? Well, maybe somebody needed to lay down a turbo turd. I don't know. I don't have all the answers. I need to think about what I say, man. What is coming out of my mouth? Okay, where am I? It's this way, isn't it? Is this the way? I really hope this is the way.
I just heard something.
The fuck was that?
I don't know. It was goddamn terrifying, though.
Well, it could be an elk, or it could be someone trying to get you to radio about a loud noise so they know where you are.
Fuck.
How about you don't do that again?
Noted. Sure, fine, whatever. Why am I so on edge? It's so bright and there's nothing around here. Why am I so nervous in... Okay, it's not broad daylight, but it's still pretty bright. Okay, I think I should be going the right way now. Kind of like the film Midsommar. Yeah, Midsommar is a horror movie set in broad daylight, but I wouldn't call this horror. Okay, we've gone down there. Let me check this. Oh, I do need to go down here. Okay. You watched Midsommar? Of course I did. Let's see here. Okay, here we are. Here we are. Okay. Let's get this freaking gate open.
I'm busting the gate down. There's nobody around, and it's the quickest way in.
Copy that.
That was so easy.
I smashed open the gate. Should I try to fix or hide this?
No, screw it.
Okay, then.
Okay, let's see what's in here. What in the world could be going on here? Oh, here we are. This is dangerous. Thank you very much for the super. I'm a little bit too preoccupied to read them now, but I'll do a super chat reading once we decide to end this, whenever that may be. This is really pretty, but I'm like not feeling it at the moment. Maybe just a little bit. Sorry. Getting kind of dark. Oh, right, I do have a flashlight. Thank you for reminding me.
In the heck?
Okay, I'm at the site. I don't see anybody around.
Lucky for us.
Yeah, lucky for us. Dee, there is some serious comms equipment out here. Wireless stuff.
What do you mean?
I'm talking a big 20-foot tall transmission tower. I mean, they could probably listen to whoever the hell they want. They're nestled down in this valley, which makes
the
it
ground
meant
to look like this. This kind of looks like a bug. This is a bug, right? It's not meant to look like this. This is weird.
No, they're doing something with the soil out here too. It's all gritted off.
Who knows what else they're up to?
What even is this? What are they doing?
And there are all sorts of contraptions and shit out here.
Like what?
Dishes and stuff on metal legs. There are wires all over the place. I don't know. I'm not really up on high tech. This equipment is not stuff from the hardware store.
Is this like research? Like, this has to be run by more than one person, right?
I'm in their main tent.
What's it like?
It's definitely some sort of monitoring station. I think I found the thing they used to track us.
Holy shit!
You know, you swear, like, a lot.
Not the time, Hank.
Anyway, it's called a wave receiver. Looks like it picks up anything that emits a signal. It's got basic orienteering capabilities, everything.
Holy shit, Henry.
Yeah, holy shit.
You're gonna take it, right?
Yeah, of course.
Oh.
Okay, this thing is losing its mind, beeping like crazy.
I can hear it. What's it after?
I don't know. I'm gonna go find out. Okay. Shit. Got a map here that confirms they're tracking our people's...
That's really annoying. Can I stop it?
The map's got all sorts of paths and areas marked off on it. There are lines that look like some of the paths I normally take.
Are you positive it's you?
I'm not sure, but I think so. I found their main monitoring desk.
You should get out before they come back.
So, where is this thing leading?
This stuff looks like it just got lifted out of the space shuttle.
I have to tell you, if I found out this was NASA, I'd be a hell of a lot happier.
Yeah, I don't know.
This place sleeps three. They've got a row of cots here.
I want to know what that thing finds. Look, you should get out before they come back.
Okay, can I put it away? Follow the beeping device? I tried! There we are. What am I doing?
Yeah, I think this thing is responding to something in this pile of crap on the desk.
Dig through it.
What?
There's a folder of reports here.
What do they say?
They're assessments about the two of us. There's stuff in here about Julia.
Like what?
Stuff I didn't tell you. This is...
What does it say about me? You said there was one about me.
And it looks like they've been following me around. What I do when I'm out hiking? Jesus!
Henry, do you hear me?
It says that you and your boyfriend are still together.
What? We're not. They're messing with us.
Yeah, okay.
They are. How do they even know who he is? How the hell does this... I'm so sick of letting these people do this to us. We should just burn the place down.
Susceptibility to manipulation?
about it. Worst case scenario...
Delilah.
What? Think about it.
I am, and I think it's insane.
They'd be fucked.
Yeah, and how about if that fire comes up the mountain? Or someone were to die in it?
We call it in?
We call it in?
Yeah, maybe.
My God, Delilah, no. No way.
Well, maybe it's not the best idea.
Yeah, it's definitely not the best idea.
Ah, so fucking wound up!
It's all right. I'm just gonna...
Oh my God.
Back.
I don't like being here. I want to get out of here. I want to get out of here right now.
Figure out what to do.
Susceptibility to manipulation. They know things that we haven't even said. What is going on here? I'm desperately trying to figure out, like... Because they're not gonna pull something out of thin air. It has to connect to something prior. So what's the connection? Like... Oh, oh my God! Whoa!
Delilah, there's smoke coming from the site.
Wait,
I just climbed out of there and the bridge collapsed.
What the hell happened to you? It's definitely not the best idea.
It wasn't me.
What?
What do we do?
We just call it in like any other fire.
Wait, so somebody just...
Who started it? What about them?
What is happening?
The person who started it?
Yeah.
We're talking about people watching us out here who are now burning the forest and everything in it around us. I don't know what to do about that.
Except get the hell out.
Yes, get us the hell out of here.
I will.
Good lord, what is going on? So they just like yeeted all the evidence? Hey, it's all the notes I've gathered.
This receiver just picked something up.
Like a signal? It's going beep beep.
Yeah, what could it be?
I don't know. You gotta find out.
Alright, I'm on my way now.
You know what I just picked up?
No.
A fifth of Major Bueno tequila from the creek.
Are you drunk?
No! I am getting drunk!
No, what the hell?
Don't do that!
I wanted to put it on. Where did it go?
Everything has gone to total shit, but you gotta live a little.
Oh my God, I lost it. I feel like... Wait,
I
found it, I found it, I found it.
I can't think of any good reason why you wouldn't want your decision-making inhibited right now.
There, I found it,
My thinking is, I could stay up all night worried I'm gonna lose my job because of the side fire, or I could not worry and let the chips fall where they may.
That's such a bad... How did you get this job? This is terribly irresponsible.
This wave receiver.
Ooh, I like it when you think.
Ay, ay, ay. I'll just leave you alone with whatever these thoughts are.
I can't help but feel like the person who set that thing ablaze knows that we have this thing. This is easily gonna lead us into a trap of some sort. What direction is this pointing? Oh, I can't see anything. Come on. Come on, Ike. Use those brain cells. Thank you.
Please tell me I'm going the right way, or I'm gonna be very, very upsetty. Okay, okay. Progress. My guy, what are you doing?
Shit!
Wah!
What?
What is going on? What?
Dee, I found some sort of supply bag. Light camping gear, some clothes, you know, basics. But it was alarmed. I think that's what was making the receiver go haywire.
You're okay? It's not a trap or anything?
Yeah, I'm fine. But
are we gonna have to go back into that cave?
Here. I don't know why they'd be hidden out here. They say Shoshone National Forest, Cave 452. Is that the one in the canyon?
Yeah, it is. Who the hell took them?
And what the hell is in that cave?
Okay, okay, let's just think.
Says the woman with a half a bottle of tequila in her belly.
Maybe they're panicking and we're preparing to beat it. The fire has them spooked and we have new walkie-talkies, so we have the upper hand.
Yeah, well, it's hard to feel like you have the upper hand when you're standing in the dark in the middle of the woods.
Yeah.
Oh. Well, you're back in your tower. Maybe you need a drink, too.
I'm not in my tower.
I am looking at a man standing in your lookout, and it's not you?
It is not me.
Oh my god, go.
I'm going.
Oh, that's bad, that's bad, that's bad, 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 bad. Oh, that's bad. Where the heck is the lookout? It's dark. Did I leave the light on or not? I'm scared, I'm scared, I'm scared, I'm scared, I'm scared, I'm scared, I'm scared.
I don't see anyone up here.
He was just there.
We're gonna get framed.
Is that a tape player? Did he leave you a tape? What's
we're gonna get
tape,
framed.
Henry?
It's a tape of us talking down at the site. It sounds like it was recorded from somewhere nearby.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, and it sounds like we were the ones who burned it down and that it was your idea.
No.
We are screwed.
No!
Dee, just don't freak out, okay? Don't freak out.
How we-
Oh my god, what the fuck is happening, Henry?
We got new walkie-talkies, though! Why?
Bender isn't looking like such a good idea under the light of a new day, huh?
No, it isn't, but that's not it. Someone claiming to be Henry in Two Forks called a lookout in another sector early this morning and said that I knew what caused the Wapiti Meadow fire. So, I just got off the horn with that lookout who's wondering what I know, or that I'm an arsonist, or that I'm fucking losing it! Furthermore, I bet you don't have the only tape of us from last night, so someone has evidence to back it up. We need to find out what someone's been keeping in that cave.
I'm going down there now.
We don't have a lot of time left out here, and if we don't find some fucking answers, when they lift us out of here, it's gonna be in handcuffs.
We have to stick together, okay? Keep our story straight. From the first day with those girls to the person breaking in on our conversation, everything.
But we haven't done anything.
Consistent. Yeah, I suppose you're right.
I know.
We don't need to keep a story straight if we just tell the truth.
Okay, how do we get back to the cave? It's this way, isn't it? Also, the smoke is really starting to roll in from that fire. God, the sound of the generator actually spooked me just now. Oh, I'm so on edge. The key to the puzzle was in the outhouse all along. Wouldn't that be something? Oh,
hey,
boy.
You didn't actually make that call, right? To the other lookout?
No.
It just stuck in my craw. I let myself imagine how fucked I would be if you'd been lying to me. But now that I asked, I kind of just wish I hadn't.
Of course I didn't. No way. They're trying to pit us against each other.
I'm at a loss for words at this point.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right.
That's not gonna happen, though.
Thanks, Henry.
I feel like she's the one that's not honest with me.
Okay, let's see what is actually in this place. Okay.
What the hell?
No, you have got to be kidding me. No, you better not.
Delilah, someone locked me in the cave. Is this thing working? Delilah, send someone to the cave, please! Can't get any damn reception.
Oh, well, ain't this just freaking fantastic.
Jesus, this is a big cave.
Is this actually gonna work? This is terribly dangerous. There's gonna... how big is this place? I feel like the animation bugged out there.
It's freezing in here.
Are you telling me that I cannot get reception here?
Is anybody down there?
Sorry, not the time. God, sorry I'm so quiet. I just... kinda scared I'm gonna get ooga booga'd. Like it's gonna open up. Come on. There's no way that you're not getting any reception here. Really?
Oh my god. That fire must be right on top of us.
Hey, are you there?
Yeah, what is it? What did you find?
Nothing yet, because someone tried to trap me in there.
You saw someone?
No, someone slammed the gate behind me and then ran away. I found another way out, but if I hadn't, Jesus!
So you didn't find anything?
No.
Where do I go from here?
Where someone had sunk an anchor, but the hardware's gone now.
Also...
I don't have any climbing equipment.
I just have my ropes. I'm gonna hike back to Two Forks and see if I can find anything that could double as an anchor to use in the spot.
Well, that doesn't sound dangerous.
Yeah, let's not go there. This way, I guess? What is this?
Delilah, I just found an outcropping that someone was using as a little fort. I think it was Brian Goodwin.
Really?
Yeah, he built himself a real castle. He was in the middle of really sprucing up the joint when they left. Huh, Brian stole his dad's climbing gear, his anchors.
That's convenient.
Yeah, it is. I think he was gonna hide them in a cash box or something and never got around to it. He left a note for a ranger to find them and send them back to him in Nebraska.
Huh.
Because he hated climbing?
Yeah. It sounds like Ned was pushing him, and pretending to lose his anchors was the easiest way to put a stop to it.
I hope it worked. God, what an asshole.
Yeah.
Okay.
Man, that is the sort of thing that would have caused me to catch a beating growing up.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't put it past old Ned.
There's a ham radio schematic here, something Brian was working on.
Yeah, I think that was the one thing Ned did do with him. You know, tinkering on stuff like that.
Okay. I'm gonna pretend I understand most of this.
There's also a postcard here from Brian to, I guess, his neighbor.
What's it say?
That he's with his dad and sorry he can't mow his lawn this summer.
Oh, gosh.
And also he was worried his dad didn't know when school started. I'd say that's a lucky break if I were him.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. Ned didn't really seem like a, you know, with it dad.
It's a little weird that he'd just leave so much of his stuff out here.
Well, maybe they were in a hurry when they left. Like I said, he wasn't supposed to be out here.
Yeah.
They almost got busted. Brian liked to go out on the railing of the tower and
wait the chute
to dump water on fires.
Oh,
and...
no.
I got a call because someone thought a kid was up in Two Forks. I lied and just said it was Ned. If I ratted him out, they would have been forced to leave, and I don't know, I guess I just felt like I was saving him from whatever shitty life Ned was gonna bring him back to. Not that it ended up mattering.
I don't like where this is going.
Bunch of rocks stacked up, you made a wall and a perimeter.
God. Yeah, that's perfect.
You know, maybe he made it because he was afraid of them.
Whenever I think of Brian possibly going through this crap, I get sick to my stomach.
Yeah. Sorry. Hey, remember that pack I found?
Back on your second day? Yeah.
I found a plan Brian drew about how he was going to get it back.
Oh, I'm sure it was quite elaborate.
It's some Wile E. Coyote stuff, I'll tell you that much.
That's the pack we found. I don't like where this is going, man.
Brian was doing a science fair project about bouncing radio waves off of a meteor shower.
Poor kid left his homework?
Yeah. He must have been pretty smart, huh?
Yeah, sharper than a lot of the grown-up knuckleheads I'm used to, yeah.
Yeah, but not smarter than yours truly, right?
Wait, are you seriously feeling threatened by the intelligence of a 12-year-old you've never even met?
I'm just saying, I'm pretty, with it. I'm a pretty bright bulb.
Yeah, Henry, you're a regular Rhodes Scholar.
Nice. I found an old school folder. Brian was a hell of a doodler.
Yeah, no kidding. Okay. Sorry I was so quiet during that. I believe that was everything? I didn't miss something. At least anything important. There was another one of these in the cave. I should go back for that.
What do you think is in there?
There's gotta be something. Why else try to kill me? I don't know, really. I mean, we gotta find out. What do you think?
Whatever it is, they don't want you telling anyone about.
I mean, they closed the door when they could have just...
bashed your head in with a rock or chopped you up with a...
Are you serious with this shit right now?
Yeah, I was about to say.
God, are you sure you want to go back in there?
Yeah.
Honestly, I just want to know. I want to know what is worth doing everything that's been done to us.
Yeah.
Yeah, me too. And not going to jail would be a nice kicker.
Yeah, I can agree with that. One moment. Needed to administer a bonk.
Oh, also, those girls turned up. Looks like
you didn't.
Oh,
thank God for that.
Nobody did. They took some farmer's tractor for a joyride down in Riverton and, landed in jail.
Dodged a bullet there.
Yeah. We've got enough unanswered shit to answer for, I'd say.
Mm-hmm. Well, I would be lying if I said that I felt sorry for them. Kinda had it coming. Okay, let's do this again. Okay, where is that thing? There. Now, if this stays in there and doesn't disconnect, that would be very cool. I've already taken a fall like this at the beginning of the game. Don't need to do it again. I'm either gonna get jump scared here, or I'm gonna find something I'm really not gonna enjoy. This is incredibly cramped. I would never go here myself. This is, like, surprisingly vast. Ugh. God, this is dangerous. Thank you for the super sticker. Okay, it opens up here.
Ah, shit. Oh God, you're probably a good one. You fell. Your stuff gave out.
What I was afraid of. Does that mean that the person who is out here is his dad? What was his name? Ned? But for what point? And why harass the hell out of us? None of this is making any sense. Like, I'm starting to piece things together. The only thing that is, like, nagging at me is why. I don't know. I don't get it.
Why go through all of this? Is it guilt? But what do Henry and Delilah have to do with it? I hope this makes sense. Part of me still feels like Delilah isn't telling us everything. Okay, here we are, here we are. Let's go back to the tower. Oh wow, this is...
Hey, D.
There you are, I've been worrying my ass off.
You need to call search and rescue.
What?
There's a body in the cave. It's Brian Goodwin.
Gotta be fucking kidding me. How does that... What? I don't... How?
Climbing, I think, or made to look like a climbing accident. I think that's just what it was. I mean, he was probably exploring the cave and maybe his rope gave out. But whoever locked me in there probably didn't even know about him. Delilah, you should have told someone he was out here.
Just stop. Okay, I know.
Maybe he would have...
Henry, you insensitive shit. You don't think I know he'd be alive if it weren't for me? And I fucking know it's my fault. I'll never forget that it's on me.
That fire must be right on top of us.
You see that plane?
No, I was just busy packing up.
Well, there's gonna be a lot more. The service says this thing is 2% contained.
Well, is this the Flapjack fire, or the site fire, or...?
Well, the two fires merged into one unmitigated disaster. They're renaming it after my lookout. You about packed up?
Shouldn't we talk for a sec, you know, about things?
About what?
Yeah, we still don't know that.
We still don't know who was listening to us, who was following me around, who made that tape.
All we have is the body of a dead boy who did nothing wrong.
But maybe we can still find these people.
Look, I think whoever's out there caused the site fire to cover their tracks, and I'm almost certain that when I get off the helicopter, I'm going to be led into a room and made to listen to a tape of me saying we started it.
And we don't know shit. What can I do?
Well, there's something for you to do. Holy shit.
Holy crap. Yeah, oh my god.
We don't know what it is. It could be nothing.
Yeah, it could also be whoever was listening to us.
This is a trap.
Okay, yeah, look, you should pack up everything you need in case we get the call and you can't come back.
All right, look, if something happens...
I'll remember you.
Oh, well, that's nice.
Oh, this is awful. This is a terrible idea. I swear to God, if Henry dies, I'm gonna be so angry. Okay, where the heck am I going? This way? Where is this leading me? I feel like I'm flailing around. like in the midst of nowhere. Please tell me I can go around here. Okay, good, 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 good. Okay. Okay, okay. What's that noise? BS gave me a... Are we doing okay? Are we back? Are we back? Give me a one in chat if we're back. Okay, cool, cool. Sorry about that. Okay, am I dumb or something? It should be here, right?
What's your status?
I think I'm getting close.
Alright, well, I just got word that they are coming to get us. My place.
You sound worried.
No, it's just...
Brian?
I'll coordinate with the evac team and let you know when to head towards the tram. It's north. Far. Past where you found that cut back in May. There's an emergency tram out there that will let you hike to the rendezvous point at my lookout.
Okay, 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 okay. I think we're getting closer. Please tell me that there's answers for whatever the heck is going on here.
Someone left a rope for me to climb up. I'm down near the lake.
How do you know it's for you?
There's a tracking collar tied to it. Someone was leading me here. And there's another tape.
Found the surveillance operation.
Okay, what does that mean? What is it?
It was Ned Goodwin. He was the one listening to us, just him.
Ned Goodwin? He made the tape?
Yeah. He's gone. Deeper into the Shoshone. He doesn't want anyone to know he's out here.
Because he killed Brian. Because he killed his fucking son. You need to get back here. They say the helicopters are making rounds.
Okay.
I still don't quite understand what this was all about.
Do they hold resentment towards each other, I guess? Can't help but feel like I'm being very slow.
He... God.
What?
Nothing, just some of Brian's stuff. Brian was a nice-looking kid.
Yeah.
Goodwin was the one who wrote the reports I found at the site. He wrote down everything he did to us, and everything he did every day. He was scared shitless.
I bet.
Never fuck. Sorry, that kind of made me laugh. Supervisor, goddamn. I shouldn't be laughing at this, I'm sorry. Oh, this is whenever he messed up.
You should see some of the stuff he was working on. I guess he had a lot of time on his hands.
That explains all the stuff from the snowmobiles.
This boombox looks familiar.
I'm sorry. I don't know what to say. I don't know what you want me to say. We're in the middle of a fire that is at 22,000 acres and growing fast.
It's gonna burn all of this up.
Well, take a picture if you're so keen to remember it.
You're not?
I don't know.
Maybe I will.
He had quite the view. He's got a radio base station up here. He was listening to us on that.
I just noticed that Delilah has completely stopped responding. I don't know if I like that. I don't know if she's left or if she just doesn't care. I don't know what to think about anyone anymore. I don't know. I just don't know. Where do I go? Everything seems to be going to absolute hell. North. Where do I go? Up there, I guess. Am I facing the right way? I don't think I am. I can't get down from here, can I? No. I have to go back the way I came. Man, this is depressing. I don't know what to think. I don't know what to believe. I just feel kind of down, man. It's just two people dealing with grief and guilt and a child that unfortunately passed away in what I presume is an accident. It's nothing but tragic, honestly. God, how do I get out of here? Please don't tell me I die in the fire if I mess this up. No, this... Oh my god. Where am I going? I'm so stupid. Hold on. Where am I? Okay, this way. Okay, this is... My shitty boss is gonna get me killed, Hill. Let's climb up this once. Once more. That sounds lovely.
I know I should be relieved.
Oh, there she is.
Relieved that there's no evidence of us starting that fire. Relieved that we're not crazy. That there wasn't some conspiracy. But I'm not. He was a sweet kid. With a shitty father who hid out here like a coward after dumping him in a hole.
Delilah, I think it was an accident. And I don't think Ned meant to kill him.
We don't know what happened for sure.
Ned wanted his son to be able to climb and do the sorts of things he did himself, but Brian couldn't.
And how'd that turn out, Henry? I'm sorry. God, it would have been so easy to tell the truth and have him sent home. I can't stop thinking about it.
You didn't do anything wrong.
Yes, I did. And now I've got to decide whether I tell people that he's down there so they can retrieve the body or not. And if I do, I'm going to be asked about Ned Goodwin.
Dee?
Oh, fuck.
Is that a helicopter?
Yeah, hold on. Hey! No, there's one more. Yes, here, yeah. Yeah, he's coming. Okay, 1 second. Hey, they're here, but they're making rounds. They'll come back. I think I'm gonna go with them.
Wait, just wait, okay? I'm not that far.
Henry, they're here. They're waiting right now.
Please.
Henry, I don't want to meet you and just sit here in a dead boy's shadow. Okay, I don't want to do that. I know that sounds harsh.
What?
Okay, I'll wait.
I'm not far.
Okay.
Oh my god. My head is like all over the place. I feel like it's like just scrambled entirely. I feel like I just kind of went on autopilot. I didn't say or react much to anything. I just sort of got immersed and listened to everything everybody had to say. Which I am aware is not very fun to watch. I'm sorry about that. Am I going the right way now? Okay, I'm finally on the right way. No more directionally challenged, Ike. Hopefully. Huh.
music. Please don't have any of these break. If anything happens to Hendry, I'm gonna be mad, I'm gonna be sad. Okay. Please tell me I'm going the right way, or I'm gonna be really upsetty. Okay, is this the right way? I don't think I've been here before. At least I don't recognize it. Is this in? Are we gonna meet Delilah? Oh, this looks awfully
safe.
Hey,
I'm at the evac spot near the ravine. Delilah, are you there? Delilah?
Freaking knew it. I knew it. Oh, to heck with it. I would never step foot into this. It's the logo. Is she gonna be here? Is she here?
Oh, God, it's a nightmare out there. Hello? Delilah?
Of course she isn't.
Damn it.
I called it!
So this is where she was. Apple? Can I eat this? Yes, I can. She did draw. Guess that's everything.
Hello, is anybody there?
Hi. Yeah, it's me.
You're not here. I'm not mad. I'm just...
You're not mad, you're just disappointed?
I'm not your dad after you got busted smoking pot.
I just couldn't be out there for another minute.
You could have just said that.
You really wanted me to stay.
I did. And now I'm...
disappointed.
Yeah.
I know. Hey, it shouldn't take long for the helicopter to reach you.
Okay.
There's a debrief in a situation like this. Lots of questions.
Shit. So, taking stock, we found out an old lookout killed his only son and decided to become a lonely hermit.
Yes.
And we prevented one fire?
Basically started another.
Okay, so that's a wash.
I'll have to figure out what I'm doing every summer from now on that isn't this.
You're not coming back?
No, and you'll have to... I don't know.
Yeah, me neither. I don't know what's next.
Tell you what, why don't you choose for me and I'll choose for you?
What?
All right, sure. Maybe... maybe move to Santa Fe. Open a jade emporium with your sister.
I'd be trading cute ski bombs for yoga retreat hippies, but maybe that's not all bad.
That plus first option was like, bruh.
I mean, yeah.
So what about me?
I think you should go to Julia, and then you can figure it out. Maybe put that typewriter to good use. Give me a sexy accent or something if you write about this.
Yeah.
You gotta go see her.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
Henry, look, you came out to put your memories behind you, and they're still right there in front of you.
Thank you.
You're right. I mean, I think you're right.
Good.
When I get back, maybe I could,
We shouldn't focus on this summer. Next year we'll roll around, and then the year after that, and then it's just a... I don't know. My Aunt Judy called it a pause in the hallway of time.
Did your Aunt Judy smoke a lot of pot?
I'm gonna have a drink after this. I'm gonna have a fat glass.
Yeah, we'll see.
By gum, I need it.
They'll land back where you hiked up. Good luck, Henry.
You too. Good luck.
No. Henry, you keep it for yourself, okay? Bye, Hank.
What am I supposed to feel, man? Oh, there's a helicopter. Oh, a person. I'm shocked. Okay. And we're out of here. Oh, wow. That was abrupt. It ends like that? It just smash cuts? Oh, okay. I wasn't expecting that. Something told me. Wow.
When I saw you and her talking.
My brain is like full of sand right now. Oh my god, it's the picture side token. Oh man, I should have used the camera more. Dang it. Is the music copyrighted? I don't know. Hopefully not. I guess I'll mute it just to be safe. Hopefully that wasn't enough to get me the bonk by YouTube. God, the visuals were beautiful, the voice acting was great, the writing was funny. But the I forgot that there was an accidental selfie in the beginning. Wait.
This is just tragic, man. Man, I don't even know what to say. Oh, there goes the music. Well, that was Firewatch. Like, Edith Finch, like, this was quite a ride. Like, there was really pretty, like, scenery, like, the suspense. Like, I didn't know where the story was going, and to a certain extent, I feel like I still don't entirely know exactly what it all meant, but that's mainly due to me being dense. Probably gonna have to, like, sit on it a lot, think about the characters, their motivations, why they might have done and acted the way that they did. Just trying to figure out what was going on inside their heads. And I'm also a little bit curious, like, how much changes depending on what kind of dialogue choices you pick, because there was a lot to pick from. Who knows, really? Still, I really enjoyed my time here, and thank you all for coming along on this little quite emotional roller coaster of a game. It was quite lovely. I know I said I would be doing a super chat reading, and I would have done that, but I'm still staring at, like, the OBS error thing, and I'm a little bit scared. Like, if I'm fiddle around with anything, I'm just gonna have the stream crash. So what I think that we'll do is that I still have not entirely received confirmation for what I had planned on Sunday with the to be decided thing. If the preparation for that end up taking longer than anticipated, I think that we'll just do some sort of a gorilla super chat reading on that and catch up on things. And what I had planned for that will have to come at a later time. I hope that's okay. I'm very sorry. I didn't anticipate that OBS would essentially nope out on me in the middle of the stream. I'm just happy that it didn't end up, like, crashing entirely. You guys okay with that? Okay. You guys are so sweet and understanding. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. And again, like, I do apologize for the inconvenience. Okay, but with that, I'm gonna be signing off. I'm gonna see if I can sort out the little crash here, and hopefully that didn't affect anything else I have open at the moment. And I will see you all in the next stream. Thank you so much once again for coming, and I hope you have a lovely day, night, evening, morning, wherever you are in the world. Bye-bye!